The final event in the diving pool is the men's 10-metre platform competition, one of the blue ribbon events of the whole Games, a spectacular combination of artistry, athleticism and sheer courage. It's a long journey to the medals podium though. 32 divers are in the pool for tonight's preliminary round. Only 18 will survive to make it into tomorrow morning's semi-final. The top 12 from there will go forward to tomorrow night to compete for gold. Expect the atmosphere to hit fever pitch tonight because Great Britain's poster boy Tom Daley begins his personal quest for glory, having missed out on a medal in the 10-metre synchro competition when he and Peter Waterfield finished just out of the frame in fourth place. The Brits are in action tonight and they've brought their support as ever. But the world's best are all in the lineup here. Two Olympic champions, two world champions. The Chinese have dominated in the diving pool again, but Russia's Ilya Zakharov, who won at gold at 3 metres, as we look at Tom Daley and Peter Waterfield there, they're the ones getting the cheers. Well, that Russian has proved the Chinese are not completely unbeatable. Indeed, 10 metres is supposed to be the Chinese team's most vulnerable event. Mind you, they've only won gold in 3 of the last 5 Olympic Games. We'll explain the scoring and some of the more technical aspects as we go along, but the important thing here is just to enjoy a great show. Steve Rabilliard is alongside me looking to do just that as well. Steve, you spent a lot of these games covering the gymnastics, and in many ways, is this what these guys are? They're gymnasts.
Well, they are really, and you're going to see a lot of the skills from gymnastics transfer across to the 10-metre platform. They've only got 3 seconds, though, to get it done from platform to water, or even a little less than that, and 6 dives each in what is quite a lengthy session for them. And as you mentioned, Roger, it's a little bit of a marathon effort to get yourself from these preliminaries into the final. And so they don't want to start poorly. It's, in that respect, it's also like the gymnastics. You have a major qualifying day, which allows you to progress to a number of other events. In this case, it's the the platform on through to the semi-final to the final. And we wish them all well, and we wish them safe competition, because that is a long way up. And some of the competitors will tell you themselves they don't know why they do it, and they're very aware of the danger, but it also makes for spectacular sport.
They hit the water at speeds in excess of 30 miles per hour, so get it wrong. And getting it wrong is the big pressure, of course, Steve, because, again, like the gymnasts and one or two of these artistic sports, that you cannot afford to get a dive wrong, because it could be game over.
And with your first dive, there's always that pressure, no matter how experienced you might be. And Gleb Galperin will go up first, the 27-year-old Russian, and he's seen it all, done it all, been out for a spell with injuries, like many of them have. But to be the very first competitor up brings its own pressure, but it won't be unfamiliar to most of these lads who come to this level of competition only because they're very, very good.
6 dives each tonight. Each dive has an agreed degree of difficulty. 7 judges who mark each dive out of 10. The highest and lowest 2 marks are discounted. Then the remaining total is multiplied by the degree of difficulty, or the tariff that is given to each dive. Sounds complicated. The captions you'll see come up, the graphics there will make it very clear which marks are counting. So don't worry too much about any technicalities. Just enjoy the show, as we've said, because the action here can be spectacular. 11 of these divers, plus one more, have already been in action in the synchronized swimming, which at least gives them a feel of the pool. But for most of them, it's been a long, long wait to get their Olympic Games underway.
Quite a warm evening, and we're sitting up towards the top of the venue where the warm air is settling, and we are certainly feeling it. But I wouldn't mind a dip in that pool myself, but I don't think they're going to let us down there, Roger.
Unfortunately not. You'll see there's just a little bit of a glaze across the top of the pool. They put a spray on top of it because when the divers are coming down, it gets rid of that mirror effect, and they can actually judge the distance they are from the water. I mean, it's frightening to think all that is going through their mind. They tend to pick a spot on the ceiling or the outside to use as a rotation point to orientate themselves around. For those of us who don't do this sport, we don't know how they do it, really.
No, it takes a lot of courage, serious amount of training and work in the gym, and a bit of work between the ears as well to convince yourself that how it should be done and that should it be done at all. But Gleb Galperin, first of all.
One of the most experienced competitors in the competition. The dives will get more difficult as they go along. inward 3.5 somersault with a 3.2 tariff, and always so pleased to get that first one out the way.
And it looked like he did a very good job in tight to the platform. That's part of the danger, of course, and hit the water nice and vertically. And the good scores coming in for him. An 88 to start with, and four scores rejected, as Rogers explained to you, the top two and bottom two.
9 and 9.5 are excellent stuff. This is Lin Yue, who's one of the two Chinese divers. He was the 2008 Olympic synchro champion. Competing this time individually, in with 3.5 somersault tucked position.
Just managed to fold it in underneath the water, make that little somersault beneath to try and get those shins vertical. Nice tight tuck position, and gets through those somersaults early so he can spot the water. Plenty of nines coming the way of Lin Yue. And they try and drag those bubbles down with them to create the best possible entry and least possible splash.
You'll see them on the way down, the replays, which I should emphasize, the judges don't see those replays. We do, you do, but the judges have to get their judgment right in one go. Victor Ortega from Colombia, his second Olympic Games. And he kicks off for the back 2.5 somersault, 1.5 twist, piked.
Oh, just rolled that one over with his feet, and that's a little error that the judges never miss. Certainly seemed to get through the twisting okay. Spots the water now, and those feet just roll over. So no chance of nines there.
The judges are looking for that tightness in either the tucked or the piked position, just how close you can get your torso to the thighs and really bunched up there.
So he's getting up a few points to the early divers already, but the chances to make them up, of course, with this long first session.
Anton Zakharov from Ukraine next to go, not to be confused with Ilya Zakharov from Russia, who won the synchro competition. In with 3.5 somersault tucked.
Popular starting dive, and it gives you a chance at home to compare how well it's performed.
Closeness to the board is just unnerving at times, isn't it?
Yeah. And I don't think he was still a little bent at the hips as he entered the water, so wasn't quite vertical, hadn't quite come out of it. A little concern there, I think, for how tight he was to the platform. And 72 for Zakharov.
Timofey Hodychik from Belarus, 10th in the World Championships in Shanghai in 2011 as his best performance to date. Back 2.5 somersault, 1.5 twist, piked.
And maybe just slightly under rotating as he hit the water, as opposed to Ortega, who overcooked it. A little bit of a loss of leg form there as the ankles came apart. So it sounds too like the judges have spotted what we have. The ankles just couldn't quite lock themselves together. They actually came apart twice. So 72.
Hyun Joo Ri from the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, just 16 years of age. There's a lot of teenagers in this competition as well. Forward 3.5 somersault.
Galperin's 88 is still standing at the moment, but we're expecting the Chinese competitors here to do a wonderful job. It's so graceful. And you see that he's absolutely ripped that entry. There's barely a splash. Just drags all the bubbles down with him.
2/8 and an 8.5 there. This is Jimmy Connor from Australia, 17 years of age, from Melbourne. Lives in Brisbane, trains there.
And he's just rolled the feet over there. He won't be too pleased with that first effort. He was the youngest in the Australian team at the Delhi Commonwealth Games. He was just 15. He's come to the top quickly and early, but not perhaps his best opening dive. And as the sevens come in, he's entitled to be nervous.
Frighteningly young, some of these competitors. Quite an age range right up into the early 30s, like Peter Waterfield from Great Britain, one of the more senior divers in the whole competition, down to 15 and 16 year old young boys, really. Martin Wolfram is age 20, from Germany. Arm stand back double somersault 2.5 twists, an ambitious opening dive. These arm stand positions are really heart in mouth for all of us watching.
High tariff to start off with, that 3.6. See if he can cash in. Well, okay, you consider the degree of difficulty is going to help him, but the execution, not perfect.
The lower tariff dives have got to be executed absolutely spot on. You've got a little bit more margin for error on the higher, more difficult dives, but obviously they want to cash in, don't they?
Yeah, and a different sort of error there. He wasn't quite square to the water. His feet were twisted, ankles certainly together. And that, again, should be an error that the judges can catch at first look, their first and only look.
Yenkla Aguilera from Cuba, his second Olympic Games. Aged 22. Another forward 3.5 somersault.
Well, he crashed into the water, really. That was hardly missable. The error is on the entry. Knees a little bent in the pike position. There's a few problems here for him. He wasn't square. And it is the errors that the judges are looking for. We certainly don't mean to sound negative about these great divers. They're at the Olympics because they're the world's best. But when we're trying to reflect the thoughts of the judges here, and the 61.5 that's the lowest so far. So he had a few problems.
Next up is Alexander Bondar from the Ukraine, who's already competed in the synchro competition with Alexander Gorshkovozov. Finished 8th in with 3.5 somersault to begin his routine.
Well, very tidy. Should do well here, Bondar. Not too many identifiable problems with his opening dive.
Some of the Eastern European divers are a little bit more powerfully built, which does tend to give a different impression. They're almost more muscular divers than some of the Chinese divers, who are so incredibly slight and whippy through the air, aren't they?
Yes, and there's less mass entering the water. It gives the Chinese divers a better entry quite often, but the powerful men can certainly get the job done in a different way.
Jiho Park from Korea.
The ankle's just rolling over a little for Park, out of Busan in Korea. Had a successful Asian Games. He's third in the synchro 3-meter springboard. And 72. Equals 7th best mark.
Going to take a long time for these positions to really make a huge amount of sense with 32 divers to get through. Really a question of them getting this evening out the way, making no mistakes, getting a feel for the competition, and maybe at the top end laying down the odd marker if you're amongst those with high aspirations. Viktor Minibayev from Russia, 6th in the 10-meter synchro as well. Inward 3.5 somersault tucked.
Well, he was there a long time. And I wonder if there were a few stray thoughts entering his mind. The execution was solid until he kicked out for the entry and he was just caught a bit short. So that large splash is such a giveaway. A little bit of a split in the tuck position. Most of the divers have that. It doesn't upset the judges too much. They really only see that from side on. But Minabayev has paid a penalty for the entry for sure.
Got to get the right push off as well to get through the rotations in time to unwind, to give themselves the chance of the clean entry. There's no spring on that. Obviously, it all comes from the their own push off and their own technique. German Sanchez from Mexico. Silver medalist in the 10-meter synchro. Mexico have had a decent games in the diving pool.
Such a strong nation in this sport, Mexico. Oh, nice. The crowd really appreciated that entry. They're instant experts, like everyone at home. But you learn to pick a good dive, don't you? And the entry is such an important impression to leave.
They call it the rip, don't they? And you can hear that different sound. He's only 47K, that's 7'6". He's one of the lightest going, and really the spin speed there in his rotations.
And he's earned the top mark so far. Galperin, the first diver, was leading for quite a time there with 88, but now 89.1 for German Sanchez.
Well, his strong performance in the synchro would certainly have upped his confidence, and confidence, as in all sports, but this in particular, is massive. And you can understand why from that formidable height. Riley McCormick from Canada.
Again, a very nice entry from Riley.
His second Olympics. He didn't make the final in Beijing, finished 16th. So his first aim will be to not just get through tonight, but tomorrow morning, and be in the final would be good for him.
He'll turn 21 in a couple of weeks. And he's made a very solid start here. 73.5 leaves him in equal seventh position. And now lots of interest about our next competitor.
Yep, one of the stars of the show, the superstar from Beijing, Matthew Mitchum. He is a big man, isn't he?
Well, he's a big star in Australia, that's for sure. His face has been all over the pre-Olympic publicity because he's a defending champion. But I think even Matthew would admit that the entry here wasn't quite what he was looking for. The ever so tiny over-rotation of the feet.
First Australian male to win Olympic gold medal in diving since 1924, when he got it 4 years ago in Beijing, in the most spectacular fashion, with one of the great dives of all time in the last round to snatch victory.
Loves competing, you see that with a smile.
Armand Gismervik of Norway.
Opening back 2.5 somersault with 1.5 twists, and he got through everything here pretty tidily. Feet just came together a little tardily, but he's going to pick up some nice marks here. Gismervik with an 81.6. Anything in the 80s is going to leave you in good stead for your second dive and onward. It's German Sanchez, huge first score of 89.1.
Francesco Dell'Omo from Italy. This is his third Olympic Games, so an experienced competitor. Forward 2.5 somersault with one twist, piked.
Very nice, bringing lots of experience to bear here. Ninth in the platform back in Athens, 04. Didn't make the final in Beijing. Not too much wrong there for Francesco. Just a confidence building start, 72.5. We'll need to build on that.
Varying degrees of pedigree in the country's diving history, really. Divers like Christopher Eskilsson from Sweden. Don't have a massive tradition in this sport, and facilities sometimes more limited. Back 2.5 somersault, 1.5 twist for his opening dive. I think he's one of the divers who's really looking to get into that semi-final first as a benchmark of progress and achievement.
He's done a nice job here. Try and get through the twists as early as possible. Square yourself up for the entry, and not too much wrong there from Christopher Eskilsson, 23 years old, trains in Malmo. It just bothered me a little that he wasn't quite square, but 76.8, that's all right. He's top 10 at the moment. 32 in the field, of course, at this stage.
Eric Sain from Canada, his first Olympic Games. Had success as a synchro diver, but he's on his own with a back 2.5 somersault, 2.5 twist. And again, quite a high tariff dive to open up your program with.
Yes, and he didn't quite get through it. There was a big splash because he wasn't vertical. A little bent at the hips on entry. This will show us so much more clearly, the slow-mo. Oh, his knees were bent there. There were a number of problems there, and the judges have hit him hard. Oh, it was messy. I'm sorry. I want to be more complimentary, but he put the tough one in early, maybe to get it out of the way, but 59.4 is not too special.
Not in your first Olympic dive. Brian Nixon Lomas from Malaysia. Arm stand, back double somersault, 1.5 twist to start his program. His third Olympic Games.
Very nice. Created a good entry, even if he wasn't completely vertical. So he's ticked a couple of boxes and maybe left one unchecked. But he's a former world junior champion, and he created history for Malaysia when he achieved that in 2004. And he's going to get some good marks here, and with a reasonable tariff, he'll be okay. With an 81.6. So that's good enough for an equal fourth position at the moment.
Next up is Ivan Garcia from Mexico. Other half of the silver medal winning duo in the 10 meters synchro. With German Sanchez, just 18. Opening up with a forward 4.5 somersault. There's some spin speed going on there. That's a 3.7 tariff as well.
Not afraid to put the tough dives in early. He's got a 4.1 coming later. Well, the feet did roll over. There's a lot of somersaults to get through in time to spot the water and get yourself vertical and square. So, but 81.4. Seventh.
Well, the United States have had a bit of a diving revival in these games with such a huge early tradition in the Olympic Games coming from the States. Nick McCrory has a bronze to take home in the 10-meter synchro with David Budaya, who's to dive in a few minutes, but he gets a chance to open his program. Inward 3.5 somersault.
Well, almost zero splash. Gets a warm round of applause here from the crowd that will be reasonably neutral until the British divers come up. He can show that bronze medal to his uncle, the British swimmer, who in 1976 picked up bronze in the 800 freestyle, Gordon Downey. But, of course, Nick McCrory representing the USA. At a 76.8, more than respectable.
The announcer just asking the enthusiastic crowd to turn off the flash guns in their camera phones and cameras they brought to record the event. pointing out there is quite enough light in here and you don't want to distract the divers. Jose Guerra from Cuba getting on with his dive very sharply indeed. Forward 3.5 somersault.
A little too quickly perhaps as the feet just flipped over at the end of this one. So Guerra will be penalised for that with 6.5s and 7s. A shame, a lot of the other parts of that dive were nice, but that last impression is just vital. It's a bit, as we compare with gymnastics, it's like sticking the landing after a tough routine. If you don't get the entry right, the judges have just left with a bad impression.
Sebastian Villa next from Colombia. Back 2.5 somersault, 1.5 twist. That's a 3.2 degree of difficulty.
Oh, very nice. He had a bronze medal in the Pan Am Games in the 10-metre platform last year in Guadalajara. That's a sports festival that's sort of gaining in prestige. And he's attracting eights. And that's a top 10 dive at the moment. Still plenty to come.
Next up, one of the big hitters, as we just see those marks confirmed there. David Budaya from the United States. Bronze in the 10-meter synchro. 5'9", a much bigger build diver than some of the 5'4", 5'5s that we've seen already. Arm stand, back double somersault, 2.5 twists, 3.6. And opening the show with a big number.
Well, okay, I'd be glad it's got a big tariff because there were a couple of small problems there. Done well, this was a dive that had the chance to be up there in the top three, but you just observe the bigger splash there.
He likes the difficult dives. He chose the highest degree of difficulty in the finals in 2008 in this event and finished 10th. So he likes to challenge himself, obviously.
First US diver to score 600 plus points under the current scoring system. And Dyer, eighth.
Now, here's the star, possibly the favorite, Chu Bo from China, the world champion. Inward 3.5 somersault to put down his first marker.
His teammate Lin is sitting in third position. Always very tidy. Oh, the judges like it. It's frighteningly close to the platform. Very vertical position. Slightly bigger splash than perhaps he likes. But into third.
Not it. Some of the big hitters have ended up down the bottom end of this in the draw for the dive order. They'll be seeded after tonight, of course. This is Sascha Klein from Germany. Twice European champion at 10 metres, in with 3.5 somersault to begin.
Well, we've seen a few of these dives in this first series, and none too much better than this one from Sascha Klein. Very tidy, very clean on entry.
26 years of age, very experienced. 8 golds and 2 silvers at European Championship level, but this, of course, is very much a level up. But a good opening.
81.6, a popular score in this first series, and four divers on that score.
Vadim Kaptur from Belarus, another one of the bigger Eastern European divers at 5'9".
He did have a head injury last year in June when he hit the platform while training with his partner Timofey Hordachek. But this is a beautiful dive. Takes some courage to come back, but where's the splash? He couldn't make one. and the 72. The difficulty just down a little. That's why he's not up in the high 70s.
The crowd, as you can hear, already cheering because up on the board is the great home hero, Tom Daley from Great Britain, one of the poster boys of the whole London 2012 Olympic Games. Still only 18 years of age, his second Olympics. So much expectation on Tom Daley. Back 2.5 somersault, 2.5 twists, and that's a 3.6 to start with.
Oh, yeah, I would like him to have done better so that the crowd had a bit more to influence the judges with, but you saw the splash. Over it came. He's so clean through the air, but just let it go at the end, and the splash won't convince the judges that this was a dive that was in control.
Finished fourth in the 10-meter synchro, doing brilliantly in the first three dives, and then they got the fourth one wrong and it cost them dearly, cost them a medal. He just has to settle down and make sure he qualifies and look to build through his campaign. He's not going to win it tonight, but you can lose it.
It's not a disastrous start, but it's not a confidence building one either. Cherubini
from Italy, inward 3.5 somersault.
Yep, well, his youth perhaps exposed with his opening dive there. His hips a little bent on entry, and the splash a little sizable. He got through the somersaults well enough, but didn't straighten out quickly enough.
He's still only 17. He was outstanding in the European Youth Championships in Budapest when he was only 14 years of age, and straight away was pitched into the World Championships in Rome in 2009. So he's grown up in competition, really.
Second last diver in this first series.
Hugo Parisi from Brazil, his third Olympic Games. Forward 3.5 somersault, made a very clean sound. The sound is almost an indication as much as the sight.
He'll get good marks here, but with a 3.0 tariff, you can't expect to collect too big a score. Nice entry, though, from Hugo. Top 15, one to come, another big cheer.
It's the other British diver, Peter Waterfield, Tom Daley's synchro partner. He's the older of the two by far, age 31. And a local boy born in Walthamstow, which is just a few miles away in East London.
Well,
he's got plenty of experience.
Waterfield, he's well named really for aquatic sport, isn't he?
His opening dive is an arm stand back triple somersault, 3.3, tucked position.
Very nice. Good start.
It's his fourth Olympic Games, so he knows what this level of competition is all about.
Kick out to start that handstand dive. Must hold that handstand to show that the judges you were in control. Biggest splash. He's not a small man, powerfully built, not tall, 165 centimeters, but
very compact, isn't he?
And a 66 for Peter, so room to improve, and he'll need to in this hot field. And that completes the first series of dives.
It's a long scoreboard to give you, but right at the top there, German Sanchez, Gleb Galperin, and the two Chinese divers, Lin Yue and Chu Bo, both right up there. Bondar, Sasha Klein, some experienced divers. And now maybe one or two who might have been hoping for more, like Matthew Mitchum and David Budaya and Nick McCrory. But these differences in points can be caught up fairly quickly. Tom Daley on the line there in 18th position. He will be believing he can only get better. They'll feel a lot better though from having got into the competition, got that first nervous dive out of the way and start to settle into their routines. As we've said, 32 divers means it's sort of a long evening when you're in a final with just 12, then you're in the water quickly and the whole competition gets a lot more momentum. Though the organisation here is excellent, how swiftly they get them standing at different levels of the board and ready to go and keep the entertainment going.
Yeah, just under half an hour for the first 32 dives, so we can expect half an hour per dive, per series, if you like. As Galperin gets ready for his armstand reverse triple.
Age 27, born in Moscow, 5'9". Had terrible injury problems. He's had 8 operations on his back and knee and didn't compete in 2010 and 2011. He broke his leg as well back in 2006. This is a dangerous sport.
Yeah, and no wonder he thought about flagging it all away, but his family convinced him he should keep going, and he's had a very good second dive here to confirm his position near the top of the standings. 2 good dives from Gleb Galperin.
Maybe these older, more experienced divers can bring that extra measure of composure to their performance.
That's the first dive in the 90s.
Lin Yue, reverse 3.5 somersault.
Oh, he's a little short on the entry there. Beautiful through the air, as always, as the top Chinese divers. You can see he just didn't kick out early enough. And he's not vertical at all. Although somehow he manages to make such a small splash. That's great control underneath the water to pull that bubble down with him.
Like many of the divers here, they did take the chance to get a feel of the pool by competing in a World Cup event, which was held here at the Aquatic Centre in February, where he finished 6th. And Victor Ortega, somebody who really likes to get on with it once he gets up on that board.
Yes. He'll help move the competition along in his own way. Forward 3.5. And again, really the only problem here that the divers mostly have is ripping that entry. 67.5 for Victor.
Anton Zakharov. World Championship silver and bronze in the synchro events. 26-year-old with his second dive. Back 3.5 somersault.
Very good. Controlled the entry beautifully. Some strength there, and he's impressed his team.
Got a bit of ground to make up, really, from his opening dive. Very tight there. Chest and thighs together. Some of them grip all the way round the back of their legs there. One or two of them just like to hold it more to the side, but you can really pull it in, can't you?
That's a good shot there under the water, the way they spread their arms out. That helps to pull the air down with them, the bubbles, and create a better entry.
Timofey Hordejczyk. With an arm stand back triple somersault. Tucks, 3.3 the difficulty here, which is as high as his tariff of dives go.
Oh dear, that was that wasn't so special, and the crowd quite muted with their applause.
These dives do give an impression without actually analyze them into elements all the way down, which the judges are doing. So the crowd, a good crowd here, very quickly getting a feel for what's going to go down well.
Well, the size of the splash alone was the giveaway for the crowd. And the 4s, 4.5, that's tough for their chick to come back from. And 4 more dives, though. It can be done. It's just you make it hard for yourself, put pressure on.
All these divers had to qualify for this competition either through the World Championships last year or being continental champion. This is Ri Hyun-ju, or having dived at the World Cup. So they've all earned the right to be here.
Very tidy through the air. Actually, a little second jump off the platform as it toes left and came on again. And splash, not quite right, the feet.
They've got to pull out of that rotation and the speed they generate then, and that's where the core strength and those stomach muscles really come into play, where they've got to basically put the brakes on in midair.
James Conner made a nervous start, I think it's fair to say, with an opening 66.
He was another one who was injured back in 2010 and trained for a long time with back pain. 18 months it went on, eventually he had to give himself a rest. But he's back now, back 3.5 somersault, tucked.
Very nice, a big improvement on his first dive, particularly with the entry from the 17-year-old. Looks like he might have a couple of wrist issues as well. But, all these divers learn to cope with injury and compete with it if they can. This is really going to lift his score. And so the tuck is quite split, but it does allow them to go through the air a bit more quickly. And 79.2, he's picked up a few barks there.
Tell by his body language, he feels a bit more encouraged there. Martin Wolfram from Germany, 20-year-old.
Well, 77.4 was his opening dive. You're starting to get a feel for what are the kind of marks we can see helping the divers progress to the next round. Biggish splash.
Semi-final will be progress for him. He competed at the World Championships last year. That was his first really big international competition. Finished 20th, so if he could get in the top 18 here, that would be a good games for him. And then you never know. Yankla Aguila of Cuba.
This is the inward 3.5 we saw a lot of in the first series. Well, oh, beautiful. Aguila. He only had a 61.5 with his first dive. And he kept that in so tight to the platform. And just take your breath away. Watch here. But it allows him to get that more vertical position. He's not pushing out too far away from the platform. If you're brave enough to keep it in that close, you can get more vertical. And he has taken some reward for his risk.
It's a hard-in-mouth moment there. When you look at those replays, it all happened so quickly. The replays really give you the chance to appreciate the sheer courage of these divers. They know what they're doing, but even so.
It's a 25-point improvement with his second diver, Grant.
Oleksandr Bondar now from Ukraine. He flung himself into that dive. You do tend to get the Eastern Europeans to really attack it in that almost aggressive way.
He's jumping way out into the pool here, and that just makes it a little tougher to get that vertical position. A nice contrast, really, to the previous diver with what we're talking about getting into the water at the right angle.
4.5 somersaults he's got to generate there. He's got to get the height and the speed going, hasn't he? And then put those brakes on.
83.25, though, with that difficulty of 3.7, that really helps.
Jihoo Park from Korea. Inward 3.5 somersault. He's got work to do to try and make the cut. 18, remember, to go through. Quick.
Yeah, and a little under-rotated at the finish to create that big splash. But again, a little gasp from the crowd as you see how tight he is to the board there. I think that his hair might have touched the platform, but fortunately not his head. All fine, kicks it out, but overdoes it. And just the giveaway splash for a 67-2.
Viktor Minibayev. Also a 3-meter diver as well. Sixth in the 10-meter synchro though already, so he's got a feel of the occasion.
Pretty good. This is his toughest dive with a 3.7 tariff. He's got a couple of 3.6s in there as well. It's a fairly savage cut after this, after the preliminaries. They almost cut the field in half from 32 to 18. Camera that slides down the pole and gives you that look and some sense of the pace. 86.95, so into the top five for the moment, but plenty of dives to come in this second lot.
Next up, German Sanchez, the synchro silver medalist. Likes this pool. He was here in February and got a silver there as well. Forward 2.5 somersault. 3 twists there.
Well, there was plenty of difficulty involved with the 3.8 tariff. He opened up, of course, with an 89.1 to be up near the top of the standings. But the feet rolling over. So he's not going to replicate that. Difficulty will help.
An awful lot to control during that dive. And he just couldn't manage to quite hold the right entry position there.
81.7. Still thereabouts, in good shape to progress.
Riley McCormick from Canada, down in 19th place, so he's just below the cut. Needs to keep improving. Back 2.5 somersault, 2.5 twists. 3.6 this one, so he can make up ground here.
A few Canadians in the crowd, perhaps, letting the judges know they approve. A little bit of loss of leg form at the top of that dive. The ankles should have come together a bit quicker than that. And just a moderate size splash. His ankles are all over the place. So he didn't really capitalize on the difficulty there. 79.2, though, more than respectable. It's just, it could have been more. Coach being put in his place.
Matthew Mitchum, the defending champion. He feels that the injuries he's had in recent years has made him one of the underdogs here tonight, and he is quite happy with that. Back 3.5 somersault. That should have improved his position, you think?
Well, 3.3 the tariff. I don't think we've seen this dive yet from anyone else. And it's almost a blind kick out, isn't it? You got to try and reach that vertical position with a little less to go by. He's the defending Olympic champion, of course. So much expected of him. And 74.25. Eighth. Kismervik didn't muck around. Roger, he's right into it.
Well, it's very noticeable how some want to really compose themselves. And while we're watching the replays and getting those results, of course, the officials quickly get them moving up there and ready to go. And some of them really are ready to go.
Very nice entry from Kismervik. Trains in Sweden. There's no 10-metre platform facility in Norway.
He's a bit of a trailblazer for Norway there in the diving. Unlike Francesco Di Lomo, Italy have had their stars in the past. His second dive. Forward 3.5 somersault.
Well, another impressive entry, and it's just a sense that the standard is now starting to lift midway through this second series. They're nose not quite on the knees, but the real impression is with the entry, and it was a beauty. And so eight and a half, there's a couple of nines in there as well. They might get rejected, but they will, in fact. Overall, though, pretty healthy effort. 76 and a half.
Lost the two nines, of course, in the scoring system, as you can see them being crossed out there. Now Christopher Eskilsson from Sweden in with 3 and a half, a somersault, 13th in round one, so he'll be reasonably encouraged by his opening dive.
Great entry. A second look here. Very tight tuck position. Spots the water. Not quite 100% vertical, but gee, you need a second look to see that. It's all about the entry.
He's competed at the last two World Championships and never gone out of the qualifying stage, so he's giving himself a bit of a chance here, perhaps.
76.8, and he's in equal seventh position, moving up from 13th.
Now, Eric Sein did not get off to a great start. He was right down the bottom of the pecking order in 30th, inward 3 and a half somersault, and he needs to get this a lot more impressively.
Well, maybe it was better, but it needed to be better than that, if I can put it as simply as that.
Like a lot of these divers, he was taken along to the pool by mum or dad, and they have a swim gym program in Canada that he turned up at one day and thought he rather liked it, and his diving career took off. As Steve said, a lot of these divers progress from gymnastics or trampolining. One or two have had injuries and think, rather mistakenly, this might be a slightly, can't be a softer option, can it? A different option, we'll say.
62.4 there for Eric Sein. So we move on to Brian Lomas.
Forward 4 and a half somersault tucks there, 3.7 the tariff.
He's named in part after one of your great footballers, Brian Robson. So his dad must be a huge football fan back in Malaysia.
And Brian Robson wouldn't have held back, I can tell you that. He'd have been diving, he really would have given it the full face of the bat.
Well, the trouble for this Brian was that he wasn't, didn't quite straighten out the legs below the hips here, and he's come in at a bit of an angle.
Malaysia never won an Olympic gold medal before these games, so it would be a great incentive, but might still be in the dreams, perhaps.
His second dive just letting him down a little as we move swiftly on.
Ivan Garcia, now up in ninth place, right on the edge of that board, back 3 and a half somersault. That in itself a real test of nerve for most people.
Oh, very good.
And they do have to take their time in that position and make sure they've got the composure right on the edge of the board there.
No spring to be had out of concrete, so they really need the power out of the legs. And he has controlled that entry beautifully, Garcia. And he's getting a sprinkling of nines for this dive, which will really move him up the standings. Third.
It's a great camera angle, that top shot looking right down. Really gives you an idea of the view from the top there, which is formidable. Nick McCrory from the United States. Arm stand back, double somersault, 1 and a half twist. He's 13th equal. This in itself a test, getting right to the edge of that board.
Basically three stories up in the air.
Ah! agonizing wait at the top there.
It was, wasn't it? I just thought, is he in control here? Has he got all his thoughts together? But the execution was fine. He did kick out a little horizontally, and I was wondering if he was going to get through all that he had to. But he reached a beautiful position for the entry, and it was well in control.
The nerve at the top of that board to just hold on until you know you're absolutely right. We know how much they practice, but even so, in this atmosphere, with this pressure and expectation, you really have got to admire their skill and their sheer nerve. Putting the towel down, quite a few of them there, just to get that little bit of extra grip and feel. Jose Guerra of Cuba, back 3.5 somersault.
Had a poor first dive, needs this to be good. Oh, it's not. Oh, dear. Well.
Your heart goes out, doesn't it?
Yeah, and his head drops. He knows all too well that this went seriously wrong. He's kicked out too early, and he's almost hit horizontally.
Well, he did complete the dive. If you do complete the dive, you will get a score. Like, if you just sort of opt out half through, then it will be deemed to be incomplete, and that is a zero. But to be fair, the crowd were really supportive there, I thought, and sympathetic. Sebastian Villa now from Colombia.
I think the crowd realised that what these men are doing, they could never do, so there's that respect.
Inward 3.5 somersault piked.
Made a good start with a 78.4. May not get full value here with some problems on the entry. I like his form through the air. Wonderful position there. Spots the water, then twists. And must be square on as well as vertical. He wasn't quite either. 71.75 though.
Next up, the synchro bronze medalist from last week, David Boudia, who does confess that he's been to see sports psychologists because he doesn't have a great deal of confidence with heights, which is a bit unfortunate when you're standing on the edge of a 10-meter board, but he's got an inward 3.5 somersault now.
I think he's got the problem sorted, but I'd need the same, I think.
He attacked that, though, didn't he?
One of a number of divers to score in the 80s with his first. Not quite so prodigious with his second. Hands are flat as they enter the water. They're not pointed, and that helps create a hole to for the body to follow into the water with. 73.6 for Badaya.
Next up, the favourite, Chu Bo. Got 25 perfect tens when he got a historic 609.20 at the Diving World Series in Beijing last year. Arm stand, back triple somersault.
My goodness, what an entry. How does he do it? He does it with a bow. And there was no splash. It could have been a pea entering the water. And the judges love it. There's a 10 in there.
Look at that entry position.
Well, a couple of those 10, well, the two 10s, unfortunately for him, get cast aside, but it is a very high score for Chubo. What an impression to leave. 99.75.
They really are poker-faced throughout their program, the Chinese divers. They really don't like to let their emotions come through, so controlled all the way through the evening. And it's a long evening for them. Sascha Klein now from Germany. Forward 4.5 somersault.
Well, he got away with a good entry there, having not really established a vertical position.
He might feel he's in that group outside the big guns, challenging perhaps for medal honours as the next 24 hours passes.
Plenty of somersaults to get through. good entry, just hips slightly bent there, but 88.8, I'm not going to argue with that kind of mark. Klein into fourth position at the moment, early in the prelims.
Vadim Kaptur now from Belarus, with work to do, inward 3.5 somersault, with which to make some progress. 3.2, the tariff.
And again, one of these inward dives that has the crowd a little concerned about how close he was to the platform. Us two, judge it for yourself here. Ooh. Makes a beautiful entry though.
Well, while we wait for those very solid marks indeed, the crowd are already getting excited because it's Great Britain's Tom Daley on the board next. He and Jessica Ennis were the two pre-games faces that you saw absolutely everywhere in the country. Jessica's got her gold, which doubles the pressure on Tom. Inward 3.5, somersault tucked. Not really settled yet.
That's better. Only a 73.8 for his first dive. He can't let the field get away from him here. Almost a third of the way through the competition. Needs something in the high 70s, if he can muster it.
Well, he's been a star ever since he was 14 years of age in Beijing. The youngest competitor in the team outside of swimming. Britain's second youngest ever Olympian. World champion, of course, in Rome in 2009 at 15, and it's been one long marathon of expectation, but he's getting there.
And the high 70s is what he has achieved, so that improvement will help.
Andrea Chiarabini from Italy, arm stand back triple somersault for the 17-year-old from Rome. Didn't want to hold it too long. He was ready.
Well, that's an entry that Trubeau would be pleased with. It's barely a ripple. Pulled it in nicely. And the judge is not too impressed. And I just wonder whether he wasn't in that controlled handstand position for long enough for the judges to be happy.
Bit too anxious to get on with it, basically.
Must give the impression of control and time. And
well, they have to have control. It's just not going to happen otherwise. Hugo Parisi from Brazil.
Gives you a sense of how far up it is, doesn't it, that low angle.
Inward 3.5 somersault. Never got beyond the preliminary round in two Olympic Games before. A little bit heavy, perhaps.
And the one diver left in this second series. And he's an Englishman. Big splash there. That doesn't help Hugo Parisi's cause. Spots the water. Just not quite there. And
again, the crowd are willing on the final diver of 32, Peter Waterfield from Great Britain, who's had his injury problems. The virus before the last World Championships, he's had shoulder injuries, a neck injury more recently. But the 31-year-old is still here and competing and ready to do an inward 3.5 somersault. Well, the crowd reaction told you most things about the entry.
Well, he only had a 66 with his first dive, and he needed improvement, not a problem. And the problem is what he's had here as the legs go way over. He's just got through it too quickly. It's over-rotated.
Got a silver in Athens in 2004 with Leon Taylor in the 10-meter synchronized.
Well, he's nearly at the bottom of the field with that second dive, unfortunately, for Waterfield at 31st. So that is a big mountain to climb.
Chubo ascending to his customary position there at the lead. Gleb Galperin, German Sanchez, Sasha Klein, Ivan Navarro, the Mexicans continuing to do well. David Budaya has pulled up a little bit as well. Tom Daly up to 15th. He might have to come out of the pack, as it were, to try to get into a good position, rather like running a 10K out there on the track not too far away, where you get through those qualifying rounds in shape and look to build. That's certainly what the crowd in this fantastic 17,000-seater aquatic centre will be hoping. Down there on that caption, these are the ones who really are just wanting to be back here in the morning and to make their Olympic Games more than a six-dive wonder. Peter Waterfield there, the other home favourite, with a huge amount of work to do.
Matthew Mitchum also on the bubble, sitting in 16th position, so he can't afford to have things go wrong. But Gleb Galperin has made a very good start. Two excellent dives. That would probably be the worst of his three. Galperin was first after the first rotation, second after the second.
Forward 3.5 somersault there for the Olympic Games bronze medalist in Beijing. Didn't make the synchro team.
And just a 66 for his third drive. That's a disappointing one for Galperin.
Interestingly enough, neither of China's gold medal winning 10-meter synchro team actually made the individual competition, which is just astonishing. Lin Yue.
Oh, goodness me.
Back 3.5 somersault there, and he's starting to show his pedigree, I think.
And now we're seeing why they come to this event as favourites. What a position he adopts. What an entry he achieves. And what splash.
Slicing into the water there. Look how tight he is there. They're really hugging those legs.
That's enormous flexibility.
They're not just slim. Look at the power and the muscle definition on his thighs and the push-up and the stomach muscle strength to pull out of those dives.
There's a 100-point dive.
Victor Ortega from Colombia. Previously competed at the Olympics in the synchro event. Arm stand back triple somersault, tucked.
Well, respectable.
He was in 25th after the second dive, so he's fighting to be back tomorrow morning.
Just didn't really control the entry. He's got three more dives to try and consolidate his position.
Anton Zakharov just missed out in a synchro medal back in 2004 at the Olympic Games. One of those high speed forward 4.5 somersaults tucked with a 3.7 tariff if you nail it.
Well, it always looked like he did have it in control, not too horizontal with his takeoff from the platform. The ankles just slightly apart, made a good job of the entry. Some from column A, some from column B, as we say, right? And he's got his little support crew here.
Certainly tell the Ukrainians in that very distinctive kit they wear. Mm. Spot them a mile off.
But anything in the 80s, you'll take. And he's had 72, an 88, and an 83.
Timofey Ordejczyk. He was right down in 30th position. Forward 3.5 somersaults was the intention there.
Oh, he's come up short, hasn't he? Never got through it. And he's just struggling to reach his best in this competition, and he might be struggling to explain why. You see his head well away from the knees compared to our two Chinese stars. Just a different position. He can still make that work, but he didn't on that occasion.
Hyun Joo Ri up there on that 10-meter board from the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, just 16 years of age. Arm stand back triple somersault. Now, how quickly will he be into the dive from his hold position? Up very quickly. Oh, he's not got it there. Oh, he can do it again, but there's a time on this, and more than anything else, this is a major test.
Good luck.
Well, he had to hurry that to get into the position again, and a reminder of just how big that part of the dive is a test, and not just to be taken for granted what they're doing before they even set off.
So he had to rush it in the end, and under some pressure, he's flopped over, over-rotated, big splash, and that will be a difficult dive to come back from.
A feeling of panic when you lose that then, when it is all about composure at the top of that board, must be absolutely unimaginable.
So he's really been punished there, the score of 18.
That's crippling, that's awful. Jimmy Connor, 17-year-old Australian, inward 3.5 somersault, back in 24th. Needs to put on a bit of a show here if he's going to be back in the morning, or else he could be having a late night tonight.
Not at 17. Taking a long time to get set. Well, I was concerned for him because he seemed to be there an age, convincing himself when to go, and yet he's done a good job here.
It must be almost like getting the yips, you know, and golfers, and even they call it dartitis in darts when you can't let go.
He's got it right in the end.
Well played.
Give some concession to his youth here, one of the younger divers at 17. But it's 76.8. So one in the mid-60s and two in the high 70s. He's hanging around there.
Martin Wolfram from Germany. He was here in February in the World Cup, finished ninth at this height. Reverse 3.5 somersault.
Oh, good job. And he was 19th after the second dive. So he too is right on that cut. This needed to be as good as it turned out to be. This is a wonderful entry. And Martin Wolfram has really surged up the standings with this one. Not sure how much of that lack of a square position the judges will see. They haven't punished him for it, really. With an 87.45, some nines in there, that's a great effort.
Yenkler Aguilar from Cuba, back 3.5 somersault. He's down 22nd position, so it's within range. The difficulty here is 3.6 for the back 3.5 somersault.
Well, didn't quite get there, and this was his highest tariff dive. Or he's got another one coming for his last that's also 3.6. But these are the ones you really need to make most use of.
He'd gone to the semi-final in last year's World Championship, so he would have probably come to London expecting at least to come back for a second round of dives. But this is the world's best. It's going to be difficult.
And a big splash on entry there for Guire, and a 64.8. That won't help him.
Ukrainian Oleksandr Bondar, 18-year-old from Lugansk, with an arm stand back double somersault, 2.5 twist. And he's up in sixth place. Needs to just get that arm stand straight. He's there.
Still there.
No. It has to take something out of the shoulders, being in that position that long.
Seemed to be almost too keen to get into the twist before he'd really got himself away from the board.
Yeah, and he was bent at the hips. Bad position entering the water. The ankles came apart also, so there was some leg form issues throughout the dive. It only came together at the end, but the entry was not too special. So a 57-6, and Bondar is going to plummet down the rankings. When all said and done, after the third.
Consistency, that's the big test across six dives. Kyuhoo Park from Korea, 20-year-old. Back 3.5 somersault.
Oh, and he's overdone that one as well. He's struggling, really, Park. Not his night.
Must be so hard to put the previous dive behind you and start from scratch every time. It's a bit like a golfer stepping up on the tee again after a double bogey and needing to clear all the negatives out and starting again with each dive.
He just never got into a really tight tuck position. Even the split tuck would have helped him get through those rotations more quickly. So some technique issues there for Park.
Viktor Minibayev. Synchro partner of Ilya Zakharov. Reverse 3.5 somersault, another long wait at the top there.
Well, very nice. 11th after two dives. I don't think he's going to give up any ground with that one.
About half an arm movement at the top there. It looked as though he wasn't quite sure, and then he was all very positive.
The judges are fairly happy with it. The feet just rolled over at the very end, but very positive entry. Nevaev, after a rough start, a 67 with his first dive, 86.95 his second, and then 82.5 for his third. So starting to produce it.
Next up, it's 20-year-old German Sanchez from Guadalajara in Mexico, who's having an excellent games. His silver medal from the synchro already in his kit, and his third after two dives, and now with an arm stand back triple somersault. How long will it take him to get into that key position? Legs wide and closing.
Well, he looked more confident at the top than he did at the bottom, where the entry was less than ideal. He's got a little bit of room to play with, having come into this series well positioned.
Former junior world silver medalist at 10 meters. That was only in 2010, so they are so young, these competitors, many of them. Father's a professional footballer, so he should know a little bit about diving. There's one or two footballers, could say,
Roger,
that they've dived a little bit.
That's unkind, right? It's well worked in, though. Nice segue. 75.9 for his third, as we move on to Riley McCormick.
From Canada. 14th, inward 3.5 somersault.
Lovely. That McCormick, he'll be proud of that one, I think, especially the entry. This is a zero splash dive, if you like. It just pulls that water down with him, the air that he's created, the arms separate. There's a bit of a technique to this, to ripping the entry, and he's give him 9 out of 10 for the entry. Not that they separate them, but you know, sitting up here we can. And an 80.
from Arizona State University, combining his diving with his studies in the United States.
He wants our job, a career in broadcasting.
Matthew Mitchum.
I think he needs to make a statement now, Mitchum. He's just had a pedestrian couple of first two dives.
Inward 3.5 somersault for the defending champion.
That's better.
Well, the evidence shows that he knows how to pull out the big one on the big occasion, but he has left himself a little bit more work than he would have expected.
Very good entry, and he's going to pull some eights. And a very split tuck position, but then pulls it back together again for the entry.
Competed in the 3-meter springboard at the last Olympics. Didn't qualify for the final, but now concentrating.
And he's got a mark in the 80s to perhaps move him up the rankings. We'll see when everyone's finished three.
Armand Gismavik from Norway. Back 3.5 somersault. He's 12th. Competed at 1 meter and the World Championships. 1 meter, of course, not an Olympic event.
His problem there was that even in the tuck position, his feet weren't aligned. And the judges side on would have been able to see that, as perhaps you did too. That's an unusual error, really. And a 64.35 for Gismervik. Looks to be good camaraderie around the pool. We love seeing that at the Olympics, even at the very top level, that the athletes are friends.
We've seen plenty of that in all the sports across the games, which has been great. Francesco Dell'Uomo, because it's a lonely place, rather, at the top of that board. Inward 3.5 somersault.
Very good. Francesco will come up smiling. You sometimes get a sense of how the diver feels about it, how quickly they come to the surface. Well, I hear some of this applause. I thought that went all right. What's the crowd think? Well, they liked it.
He was a European silver medalist back in 2004, so he's had a good length career to know how to deal with these occasions.
And an 81.6.
Christopher Eskilsson from Sweden, who's not been doing too badly at 12th equal after three dives, and now an arm stand back triple somersault.
Well, he executed the dive okay, but he didn't look convincing in the handstand. Once he reached a position where he felt confident, he did move, but he hadn't held it for long. The judges aren't too unhappy with him. He was pretty vertical for the entry, even if it wasn't a low splash affair. And a 72.6. I think these the boys that are sort of on the bubble, it brings its own pressure when you get about halfway through the competition. You realize that you can't muck up a dive.
Eric Sain said it was a dream come true just to be at the Olympics, and admitted that he'd set his stall out to get to the final was his ambition, but he's got some work to do. Arm stand back, double somersault, 2.5 twist. He's back in 29th.
Oh dear, that was short. He almost fell off the platform. He's had a couple of poor dives, only three competitors below him, and I just wonder what's going on here for Eric. He's a better diver than this. Well, he'll look at that, as I'm sure he will, and realize that he can do better.
Canadian champion at the individual and the synchro events. Picked up medals, Pan American Games, Commonwealth Games, but this is a big step up, the Olympic Games.
And a 55.8 for Eric.
He's going to be disheartened by that. Brian Lomas from Malaysia. Trains in China where facilities you won't be surprised to discover are top quality. Back 3.5 somersault.
Oh, well, that's seriously overcooking a fairly straightforward dive. It's a shame for him.
The crowd reaction told you everything there, let alone what the judges would make of it. Just tumbling into it like a chimney being demolished.
Yeah, that's a 29.7. Such a low score that it could be hard to recover from with three dives to come.
And he too is better than that, if you look at his past record. Now the Mexicans are on a bit of a charge in this diving competition. Ivan Garcia, fifth. The synchro silver medalist. Pan American double champion.
And seventh at the Worlds last year. This is a competition that he's familiar with. A standard he can match.
Still only 18, so he is obviously progressing in his career. The inward 4.5 somersault tucked. 4.1 the tariff here. A big one.
Well, okay.
But when you've got that big tariff, you really are looking to play your joker, as they say, and get the almost the double points.
Let's look for the problems he had by the time he reached the water here. That the legs weren't where he wanted them to be. They weren't straight from the hips, and they weren't together at the ankles. And the judges will get him for that. Just a slight twist. 77.9 though, and the difficulty certainly helps boost the score.
On to Nick McCrory from Durham, North Carolina, studying maths at Duke University, so he'll be able to work out his own scores quicker than the judges perhaps, or do have a little bit of computer aid. Big quick forward 4.5 somersault worth 3.7.
Different ways to take the photo these days. He had the tablet out. And just watch the entry here. He made a good job with the zero, almost zero splash, but close to a vertical position. That certainly helped. But I think the judges would see that he hadn't achieved a vertical position.
Jose Guerra from Cuba, bringing up the rear at the moment.
It's worth pausing to look at that great score that Linya. He's now 15 points clear of the field. We haven't finished this third series, but 100 points will help you every time. Oh, very nice. Oh, Jose Guerra. That'll please the Cubans.
We've got a silver at the World Championships at 10 metres back in 2005, so suddenly finding that sort of form.
Well, he was nowhere after the second series. He had a disastrous second dive. He's put that well out of his mind to produce a stellar effort.
Maybe a bit of encouragement there, not just for Jose, but also for every other diver who's starting to think that he might have missed the boat. That was brilliant. As I said, it's his fourth Olympic Games. He has got diving pedigree. That's livened the crowd up as well. Sebastian Villa now. He's 17th. Cannot afford to drop his standards with an arm stand back triple somersault.
Oh, but he has. And that's well short of the vertical. I'm scanning back through Guerra's dives for 58, 21, 92. So, a model of inconsistency.
That proves he's a fighter.
Yeah. Well, that's a shame for Villa, Castaneda, Sebastian Villa.
Agony for the coaches and the family and everybody else here supporting. Fair old trek from Colombia. David Budaya, 10th so far.
It's not as far as it is from Australia, Roger, I tell you.
Very true, very true.
Very nice. There was like a second splash, if you will. He didn't quite control the air under the water there. It was a funny one.
Those 4.5 somersaults tucked.
There was a lot of tumbling momentum to try and bring under control at the end for the entry.
Well, they're putting him forward as the best American platform diver among the men since the great Greg Louganis. One of the iconic names from diving in the past, when America absolutely dominated at this event before China decided to enter and spoiled their party a little bit.
Well, he inspired many to take up the sport, didn't he? Such a master of it, springboard and platform.
And that famous crack on the board, which we do not want to see repeated. Chubo now the star.
Oh, and again, he sets a very high standard, nice and tight into the platform. The crowd is being treated here. There's some world-class diving, particularly from the two Chinese.
Just 19 years of age. He's the son of a factory worker from Sichuan. Uncle was a gymnast, and the big marks are coming out for the big dives now.
Throw out the two nines and the 10, and you're just left with 9.5s for Chubo. And a 94.05. And now he leads Lin Yue. China 1-2. No shock there.
Sasha Klein, though, wanting to make the statement in this preliminary round that he is a genuine medal contender. We'll worry about the colour of that medal afterwards. An armstand back triple somersault worth 3.5 for the German diver.
Excellent job. Good effort with that one, Sasha Klein. He's not going to give up too much ground with that, I wouldn't think, having come into his third dive in fourth position.
He's a soldier, serves in the army, who obviously are very accommodating and give him plenty of training time, I would imagine.
Looks happy with it. And a 92.75, why wouldn't you be? That's his best dive so far, 81, 88 and 92.
I think he might be on the bookies blackboard, that one. I think that Sasha Klein could be somebody who is in contention. Although the way the Chinese are starting to emerge, we don't want them just to be all competing for third place. Vadim Kaptur now.
Well, he did look to be struggling in his departure from the platform, but he knew what he was doing, got through it.
Forward double somersault with a twist after that arm stand. Not even allowed to enjoy his dive again and wait for the scores, because you know who is on next.
He's got some eights in there though, Vadim Kaptur, for a score of 74.4. And 16th, just needs to keep impressing.
Tom Daly, who was given the honour of making the first dive in this pool when it was officially opened July last year, with exactly one year to go to the day to the opening of the games. Armstand back triple somersault. He's back in 15th.
So reminding you, 18 to move on to the semi, so he's got to keep some good dives coming. Well, he's recovered that well. He had a moment of unsteadiness in the handstand, collected himself, and executed well.
Crowds absolutely love him. He's had problems as a youngster. Obviously, the terribly sad story of his father dying, who was such an influence, obviously, and a massive active supporter. He was bullied at school for a while, and such a nice chap as well.
Well, he's put such a nice dive in there, and I think... An 89.25, and Tom Daly starting to find the confidence needed to just move on to the next part of the competition.
doing a bit of a Jess Ennis there, just withdrawing into himself and keeping that composure in between dives. And they've got a long wait. Andrea Chiarabini, back 3.5 somersault. He's way down in 28th.
Yeah, he still might be down there too after over-rotating there and making a bit of a mess of the entry.
At 17, these teenage divers have a lot of chance to come again and continue to progress.
Yeah, I think you have to taste this level of competition and the pressure that comes with it to deal with it and then make the most of it next time. It's a rare Olympian who steps up first time and nails it. Especially at that age.
But you're used to seeing that with the gymnastics, where also they start frighteningly young.
Oh, they do, but not as young as they used to. They've made a few restrictions to age, and the women have to be turning 16 the year of the Olympic competition.
Hugo Parisi from Brazil. He's not having the best of days either. That back 3.5 somersault.
And he, by contrast, Hugo is 28. But he just never quite got there. Went in at quite an angle and made quite a splash. But not in a good way.
They've done that dive so many times, but it's all about delivering it on the day. Peter Waterfield from Great Britain, who is having a very disappointing evening so far. But the terrific crowd here, predictably, right behind him. Forward 4.5 somersault.
Well, this is his big dive. It's the 3.7 difficulty, and he's about to make up a serious amount of ground here. The crowd doing their best to influence the judges.
He was competing back in 1997 at World Championship level, so he does know how to put these things behind him.
Well, that was a wonderful dive. That's a view as he goes past the judges. Has got to get those feet together.
They can't afford to blink, the judges, can you?
No, it's there's actually two panels work through this long session to make sure that the job's done with fresh eyes. 94.35. Well, that's well done him. That'll help.
He looks as though he's pleased with that, quite rightly so, showing his fighting qualities. Let's check on that leaderboard then. Halfway through the competition, Ju Bo leading from the front, but Sasha Klein from Germany up there in second place. Lin Yue, German Sanchez, Galperin, the second Mexican, Ivan Garcia, Tom Daly progressing up to ninth. And just after here, the next caption will give you where the cut is. These are the people who are really under the pressure at the moment. It's not those at the top. It's Kaptur, Bondar, Jimmy Connor, Victor Ortega. They're all around that cut at 18. That is their objective, and it is tight around there. Half a dozen points will make all the difference.
See, Peter Waterfield made up some ground with that third dive, but still 17 away from that little group on the bubble, so he's got to have a couple more good dives.
But it can be done.
You only need three or four ahead of you to stumble.
Again, they're keeping very well tightly to schedule here. The one of the features when you go from event to event, not just in the diving pool, is the competition organization, how quickly they get every sport ready, and the whole thing is like clockwork, really, to a very strict time schedule.
So back to the top of the order we go.
Gleb Galperin from Russia, double world champion and an Olympic bronze medalist.
Oh, lovely dive to start the fourth. And he's never been out of the top five in the competition this evening. And I think he might just stay there. That was well executed, confidently done. This man, as we've discussed, has come back from a series of terrible injuries and a host of operations and still performing at the top.
Comes from a sporting family. His father works in diving for the Russian Ministry of Sport, and his mother is a master of sport in gymnastics, so he's got it from both sides there. Plenty of guidance.
couple in the 80s and 91, and that just that bad dive of 66 for his third. But let's enjoy Lanier.
4.5 somersault. Speed of that.
Well, he can certainly somersault, but he didn't quite pull it up in quite the right way. It's flipped over the feet here. Got that split tuck position to get through. The splash means that he won't be getting nines.
Actually, broke the 600 barrier for points in the 2010 National Championships in China. 603.45, an astonishing total. And he's rattling up the 92 there. They're just so consistent.
He's to average 100 per dive.
Staggering.
Outrageous, yeah.
Victor Ortega from Colombia. 20th, he was in with a shout, in with 3.5 somersault that needs to make progress.
He's planning to be a lawyer when he finishes competing and to give something back to the sport, which is lovely to hear. Hope he's not done yet.
Interesting, the height there off the board he got, trying to get through those somersaults almost before they go back down.
What a lovely position. And just a slightly larger splash. And a 73.6 for Ortega.
Anton Zakharov has had more success at synchro competition than when in the individual dives. Reverse 3.5 somersault.
It's just a little arched on entry there, Rogers. You won't get the full value for it.
It's looking very solid to be back again tomorrow morning, though, unless he has a disaster later on.
Fairly tight into the platform, and he was really reaching to try and pull that entry.
He's been competing at World Championship level since 2001. He's only 26, which gives you an idea for the 16 and 17-year-olds that we're seeing just how their career can develop over the long term, and they could be back for 2-3 Olympics. Timofey Hordiechik of Belarus, in with 3.5, somersault, 31st. Personal pride, perhaps his main motivation here.
Ah, that's a better one. He's had a couple of indifferent dives for the Echik. Pride might indeed have motivated him here. He's just managed to put the poor dives to one side, come up with a better one. If not quite the splash he would have liked. The divers don't see the splash, but I'm sure they get a sense of it. And a 68.8 for him. Now, Ri Hyun-ju.
From the Democratic People's Republic of Korea. He's a 16-year-old. The back 3.5 somersault. This is a competition for real experience, one suspects.
From Pyongyang, he's just finding that he can't bring his best dives to this. I wonder if we will perhaps see better from him when another Olympic cycle rolls past. But that's a very poor entry at this level.
Only 5'1". He must be one of the smallest divers in the competition, but rather deflating marks there. Now, Jimmy Connor, the 17-year-old, is just at 19th. Arm stand back, double, somersault, 1.5 twists from Melbourne, but he lives in Brisbane, trains there, splits the family up. Dad lives in Melbourne, mum lives with him.
Enormous sacrifices that families make. All sorts of ways to get to the handstand, and this is Jim's
is there.
It's an important thing. And he just over-rotated on the entry there.
It's a big strain on a young lad, not just competing here, but as we mentioned there, you know, when the family has to split up to back him, and the it's what the whole family invests in that sporting future, is a terrific pressure on a young lad.
Yes, Brisbane, some 1,600 kilometres from Melbourne. It's no overnight trip, I can tell you, to get the family back together. A 64 there for James.
Martin Wolfram from Dresden in Germany. 10th, back 3.5 somersault. Having a pretty good evening so far.
Yeah, nearly. Let's see what went wrong here. It was mainly, again, the most obvious error. He's in quite a nice position here. Nose to the knees, but didn't straighten it out in time for an impressive entry.
He'll be fairly pleased so far, though. He's sitting comfortably in the frame and just has to keep it steady and get on with his work, really.
3.6 difficulty helped him out there to achieve an 84.6. He should be all right.
Yankler Aguida from Cuba started diving when he was just 6 years of age. Arm stand back, double somersault, 1.5 twist. Back down in 20 seconds, so he needs to pull out a solid score here to keep in touch.
Certainly got through the twist nice and early, but a little bit of an angle on the entry, just a touch short.
See how the hands have got to move. They tend to put one behind the back of the head and one down the side, and they're straight away then changing hand position as the dive unravels there.
70.4 for Aguirre.
An awful lot to think about in what amounts to about 1.8 seconds the dive takes.
A lot of moving parts to get aligned at the last moment for the entry. Bondor
from Ukraine, 18-year-old. Back 3.5 somersault there, and he's 18th.
He has just nailed one there. Alexander Bondor, he's going to be happy with the score here, surely, because he has ripped a wonderful entry, and the nines are coming for Bondor.
That should really have taken him away from that position right on the edge of the cut at 18th. That's just a bit too uncomfortable going into the closing rounds.
I don't think of Ukraine as a place where they play billiards, but he does. Good hobby away from diving. Everyone needs a distraction from their main focus. Got to find other things to do. You go crazy with only one focus.
Jiho Park from Korea, 24th, reverse 2.5 somersault. Just 2.9 the tariff here. It's not going to get him a huge amount of marks when you've got a low tariff dive. You've got to get as much technical standard as possible to get the decent score.
Yeah, competitors from north and south of the border in Korea just finding this level of competition beyond them, it would seem, in these preliminaries. So Park, a 37.7, so I don't think we will see him in action in the morning.
Viktor Minibayev, arm stand back, double somersault, 2.5 twists, in 11th position, 3.6 the degree of difficulty here. European silver medalist in his first Olympic Games. Again, that long hold at the top.
Yeah, it was an impressive rise to handstand initially. Held it for quite a long time and didn't execute the back end of the dive. Through the twist, spots the water. And I think the entry is the only thing he's going to get penalised for, because the rest of the dive looked very tidy, nice leg form, good position, and just can't keep the splash down. 77-4.
Now the Mexicans, again, who have a strong diving tradition, having a more than respectable games. Two silver and a bronze so far in these games. And German Sanchez is fourth so far in this preliminary competition.
Tough dive, this one, Roger.
Inward 4.5 somersault. Watch how close to the board he gets. Got to push out and then dive, haven't you?
And get through those somersaults so quickly. You've just got to rip them around to have any chance to get... There's no running jump at these 4.5 somersaults. So that's why it attracts the 4.1.
He's through at least two before he comes back down level with that 10-meter board.
And a 98.4 with that big difficulty, working off those scores of 8.
He's comfortably back tomorrow, and with thoughts overnight perhaps of just how much potential he can bring to bear come the end of the day. Riley McCormick getting up into an arm stand back triple somersault for 3.3, ranked 13, the Canadian.
Well, he's just over-rotated a little on the entry. He was up to the handstand, the arm stand, very confidently.
Competed in Beijing when he was just 16. Finished 16th at 10 metres. And he will be looking to build on that back 4 years later.
It's 69.3 for McCormick is the lowest of his four dives so far, so ranging from that up to 80.
Now, what are we going to get from Matthew Mitchum, the defending champion? M&M, they call him.
Well, he's a bit like a box of chocolates. You're not sure what you're going to get. He's been a little bit inconsistent, at least in this competition.
Reverse 3.5 somersault with a 3.3 tariff.
Well... The splash will tell you a bit, and he doesn't want to pop his head up too early. He won't be too thrilled with the execution here.
He started as a trampolinist as well, competing at World Junior Championship level, and nearly got to an Olympics in trampolining.
Which has become quite a popular sport in Australia. He's certainly putting some pressure on himself to make tomorrow morning.
It's got to be more there. There's obviously a lot more there.
Yeah.
Can he dig it out, though?
You know, returning Olympic champions have found it so hard to replicate all the distractions that happen in the intervening years.
Amund Gismevic from Norway, the 21-year-old. That reverse 2.5 somersault only had a 2.7 tariff, so it demands a high level of execution.
And he didn't have it, Roger. There's a major splash at the end of this. Kicked it out quite elegantly, but then the toes weren't pointed. The angle wasn't right. And he's being marked down. It was very good until it wasn't.
Very few Norwegians making it to this level of competition. Francesco Dell'Uomo from Italy. 15th, back 3.5 somersault. Can't afford to get anything radically wrong, just needs to keep it solid to make sure he's back tomorrow.
Oh dear.
Quite a bit of water there.
And he was up so quickly, he didn't really manage to pull the dive down into the water and minimize the splash. He's got two dives of this difficulty, 3.3. And he's come in at such an angle, he's popped up straight away. And he's not made the most of this. Just couldn't pull the air in after him. And a 41.25 for Francesco. That will not help because he's in that area between sort of 15 and 20. Top 18 to progress, remember.
Christopher Eskilsson from Sweden, 23-year-old. Back 3.5 somersault. He's 16th, just making the cut at the moment. 3.3 the tariff here.
Oh dear, and the crowd gasps, and we'll just leave that one to the judges because you saw as well as we did. He would have seen the diver before him, Delomo, in a similar position in terms of rankings, make a mistake, and he had a chance to capitalize, just maybe move up that one more spot. But if anything, he's put in a worse dive, 39.6 Eskilsson.
So tough, the pressure, but that's what the sport is. You just have to deliver it on the day. Can't go a goal down and pull it back in the second half. It's just not that sort of an event. Yeah. Eric Sane from Canada.
That's better. He's had a fairly wretched night until now.
Forward 3.5 somersault there with a 3.0 degree of difficulty.
Well, this was a dive he could manage. He's control and really a little bit bent in that pike position, has to be acknowledged. Entry a lot better.
Some very successful synchro divers do find it a different proposition when they get up there on their own, and it's all about the execution. There's no backup scores for the synchronization, which counts very heavily in the team event, as they call it.
Now our friend Brian Lomas from Malaysia.
Reverse 3.5 somersault.
That's better. He's had a slightly erratic evening himself. Some of the Malaysian support for him. I'm sure he's a bit of a legend back home. The nation doesn't turn out an enormous number of athletes on the world stage.
In his third Olympic Games, he carried the flag for Malaysia in the opening ceremony back in 2004, when I believe he was the youngest, smallest and lightest participant.
I'm sure he managed the flag okay. And a 74.25.
Back up now towards the top of the rankings with the Mexican Ivan Garcia. Arm stand back double somersault, 2.5 twists. 3.6 the multiplier here, and he's in a decent position, sixth after round three, and you sense real confidence in the Mexican camp. Legs spread wide before close together to get that hold position just right.
Yeah, well, reasonably tidy. 3.6 the degree of difficulty, so it will be boosted by that, but there were just a question mark about whether he got through all the twists in time to straighten up and achieve that vertical position, and he was a little hinged at the hips. Is it giving the camera away with that toe? That is an angle, isn't it? We've got them all covered here. 81. For Ivan.
91 different recognized platform dives you can pick from. Every one a challenge. Some greater than others, to say the least. Nick McCrory is up next from the United States. The synchro bronze medalist. Reverse 3.5 somersault.
Well, ranked 12th coming into this dive, number four, and I don't think he'll be giving up ground there. That was a very decent effort. A little bit of a splash on entry, but reaching for the sky, tucking in tight, getting through them as well, reaching for the water. Pretty good position. Not the smallest splash you'll see, but a very solid job done with this dive.
I'm sure he will have set himself the target of reaching the final tomorrow evening. He's finished sixth in the World Championships last year.
79.2, his chances not damaged by that. Anything around the 80 keeps you just bubbling along and heading for more competition.
Jose Guerra, his fourth dive is an arm stand reverse triple somersault. He's back down in 30th position. Cuba's greatest ever diver, and he's the oldest diver in the competition.
Oh, wow. That's his 3.4 tariff. He could just be about to make a bit of a statement here at 33 years of age.
It's his fourth Olympics and competed in five World Championships. So, you know, he knows what it's all about, and suddenly pulling out that level. I wonder, is that enough?
Well, he's got a little bit of competition to come. And if he can replicate that, why not? 95.2. And he races up to 17th, but with quite a few divers to come.
Well, when you produce a dive of that standard, you're going to be absolutely devastated if you don't make the cut. Sebastian Villa from Colombia.
Well, he's going to struggle to make the cut. 25th coming in to this fourth dive. And the feet just roll over, not badly. So marks of seven coming to us via the PA, and perhaps you can hear them too. And the calculation is done, and he's got a 77.7.
Next up, David Budaya from the United States. 16 national titles and a distinguished career. Reverse 3.5 somersault.
Oh, well. Now, he was eighth coming into this dive. Some consternation there, as the vertical position certainly was not achieved. Through the tucks early. He's looking for the water now. And, yeah. Well, the feet just rolled over. Big splash. The head drops. That'll send him into the trouble area. I think he'll be all right.
Now comes the man setting all the standards. Chubo, the 19-year-old, with a back 3.5 somersault piked. Let's just enjoy it.
Oh, and enjoy it we do. He's averaging 90 for his first three dives. Really gets some power off the platform. Straight into such a tight position. Pulls it around, saves it a little. He seemed to be a bit short coming to the water, but then he's got this ability to minimize the splash and rip an entry even without perfect position.
FINA's World Diver of the Year last year. That's solid again. Even when they don't reach the absolute heights, they never let their standards drop.
86.4, he's had two of those and two dives in the 90s.
They just churn them out, don't they? Now, Sascha Klein from Germany has had a good evening so far. This is a back 3.5 somersault.
Very nice. In the pike position. So it just presents a different look for the judges to consider here.
The piked, obviously, when they grab it behind the knees, legs straight out, as opposed to the tucked when they're up there in the ball. Five foot eight is a bit more powerful type of guy. Very strongly through his dive there.
91.8. So he's had two scores in the 90s with dives 3 and 4.
Vadim Kaptur, 17th. Back 2.5 somersault, 1.5 twist. 3.2 the tariff there. Can't afford to drop too far back.
It's a steady effort. Such a distraction for him preceding a British diver. The crowd, not disrespectful, just excited. And sevens here for Kaptur.
Could have been a bit tighter in there. Thighs to chest.
And he'll still be loitering around the bubble, we think. Right in Kaptur.
Well, the 10 metres platform was one of the hot tickets pre-Olympic Games, and they were all pretty hot. And they've all turned out to see Tom Daly, who won the national under-18 title when he was only 10. Forward 4.5 somersault, tucked 3.7.
Well, the crowd liked it a little more than the judges will, I think. He was a little at an angle on entry. Saved it quite well in terms of the splash. But just check how vertical he was at the moment he hit the water. And he wasn't quite there. And the feet were just a little split as well. Well, the nation loves him, I think. And an 83.25 for Tom, but he's certainly on that form, heading for the semis.
Andrea Chiaravini, 28th, now has a reverse 3.5 somersault. 3.3 the tariff for the Italian.
He's towards the bottom of the field, so needs something special here. Just not as tight, not as convincing, not taking up as good a position for the last moment of the dive as some of the more experienced men. Toes need to be pointed here. They kind of got there towards the end, but just some form errors that the judges identify here. Knees not fully straightening for the last moment. And 54.45 for Andrea. He'll stay in the bottom half dozen.
Next up, it's Ugolo Parisi from Brazil. Third Olympic Games for him. Semi-finals would represent progress, but back in 29th, this arm stand back double somersault 2.5 twist needs to be absolutely on the money.
Well, he looked to have a good position here in the arm stand, pushed away with good strength. Twists were okay. Not too much wrong with that dive except for the finish. Not leaving that good impression for the judges, but 75.6.
Peter Waterfield, who was the Commonwealth Games gold medalist in Manchester, said the home crowd inspired him and he needs a bit of that from these supporters now to keep up the progress, because the last dive was a belter.
He's pulled out a 90.
This is a back 3.5 somersault tux, just the 3.3 tariff.
Well, again, one of those dives where the athlete saves the entry, even though they weren't quite vertical. And with a 3.3 instead of a 3.7 difficulty, which was the case with his previous dive, he can't hope to score around 90. He didn't get to the vertical. Minimal splash, but not optimal position. He's still arching on his way in.
Well, he's going to give the crowd a difficult evening because he's flirting with qualification. 18, remember, we're looking for from this evening, who will be back here at 10 o'clock in the morning. We've had a long wait through this competition at the Olympic Games, right to the end before getting underway. And here is the standings after four of six dives. Chubo, Sasha Klein, really impressive. Lin Yue, German Sanchez, Galperin, two Mexican divers. Tom Daly up to seventh now, gradually working his way up the field. Doing a bit of a Mo Farah mainly, working his way up the field. Now, this is the important cut. David Budaya more uncomfortable than he would have liked. Young Jimmy Connor just scrambling the right side of the line, but only, well, less than 3 points ahead of Yankler Aguirre. And Peter Waterfield is pulling up there and trying to claw back the ground he lost with those opening dives.
He's pretty much halved the deficit he had after the previous round. He was some 18 to 20 points adrift of the cutoff, and now he's only nine behind. So, you know, he's got two dives left and can be done, that's for sure.
It is doing it the hard way, though.
Unnecessary pressure, I think. Yeah?
Cleb Galperin kicking us off again.
Oh, dear. He's just switched off. Well, we said it's a long night. I caught one diver having a bit of a yawn in the recovery pool a moment ago. And this is just a terrible entry. It's a completely the wrong entry angle. And a 34.65 for Galperin. He doesn't score that too often.
He was ranked fifth, so he's got slack, but I wouldn't advise doing that tomorrow if he makes the cut successfully enough. Lin Yue from China. Arm stand back, double somersault, 2.5 twists, worth 3.6. And he is in third place after four dives.
His dives are 70, 80, 90 and 100 in that region.
From Guangdong province, 5'4", 8'5". Pretty perfect size and shape that for a diver.
And again, he's done a nice job of retrieving the dive at the end here. The ankles lost each other at the top, but he found the water well and didn't make much of a splash. And the judges want to give him high eights. Just corkscrewing his way through the air and into the water. And a 91.8. Well, a 3.7 difficulty certainly assists.
Victor Ortega, 16, right side of the line for the Colombian.
And he should stay there too. That's a lovely dive from Ortega.
Taken swimming when he was just 3 years of age by his parents because he was struggling with asthma, and they felt the exercise would do him a lot of good. So another example there of just how much a sporting lifestyle can help your overall health, providing you can dive off a 10-meter board, of course.
And Victor Ortega, an 84.15, keeps himself very much in contention to continue.
Anton Zakharov with an arm stand back triple somersault. Ninth, so he's fairly comfortable.
Let's watch his pike position in this one. Oh, no, I didn't like it. He wasn't very straight with his legs. And the hands go to the faces of his little cheer squad there. And he was all over the place. The knees were bent initially, got it to a straight position, then twisted, and was at less than a perfect angle coming in. And that'll hurt. 47.25.
They'll all know that if they do progress through to tomorrow and then tomorrow evening, that a poor dive is just not on if they have genuine ambitions of being in contention for the medals. Timofey Odejczyk from Belarus.
I think he's left himself too much to do ranked 29th coming into this one. See, he controlled that dive really well, and but the better guys can just give that impression for the judges with much less splash than this. He seems to hit the water very vertically and then doesn't control what happens after it.
He's reached finals in the synchronized events at World Championship level, but again, finding it harder to make an impact in the individual competition. Here's young Hyun-Joo Ri from the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, 16-year-old.
Well, I know that's a big splash, but that's actually one of his better dives in this competition for Ri, and the coach looks a little more pleased. He's had a difficult night.
But if the sport is to progress in these countries, then they have to take the risk of bringing divers to this level of competition, getting that experience and try and build that knowledge base. And it's experience too for the coaching staff, not just for the competitors, the whole team gains from the experience.
How to prepare your athletes for competition, what to say to them before and afterwards, that's all a learning experience for coaches as well as what the athletes go through.
All these individual athletes, not just in the pool, but talking about the team behind them. Jimmy Connor from Australia, the 17-year-old, who is 18th, right on the edge, reverse 3.5 somersault tucked, which he has to get fairly right.
Looks so young, doesn't he? And these vulnerable moments. Well, a fairly nice job done with that, but as Rogers mentioned, he is right on the cusp. And Zhangning Chen is his coach. Quite a lot of Chinese coaches working with the diving program in Australia, and he's getting sevens for this. You can see for yourself he's not got quite the entry he would have desired.
You'll have to excuse our understandable parental instincts coming in here, because these are young lads, and you do, if you are a parent, and millions out there watching will be, of course, you've got to empathize with what these young lads are putting themselves through. I think you'd be pretty proud of all of them if they're up there. Martin Wolfram at 20, a little bit more mature. He's eighth and not doing too badly at all. Back 2.5 somersault. 2.5 twists in there as well. 3.6 that one.
Didn't quite finish it off as he would have wanted. Looked good through the air. Got all the elements completed. Those ankles very much together. And again, just that very last aspect. The judges. It's interesting how they set them up. They can't see each other. They're sort of all partitioned off. Four on one side and three on the other. He's happy though, is Martin.
And again, we must emphasize, they don't get the front views, the top views, the side views, because you can see them really maybe yawing or not quite getting the move right through all dimensions. They've got less than 2 seconds to make the judgment call. Yankla Aguila, who's 19th and still fighting to stay in the competition. That reverse 3.5 somersault tucked.
That looked very good from here. I think he might just be giving himself a bit of room to breathe. Oh, sorry, if that's an expression. If it wasn't, it is now. Breathing room might come out better, but that was a lovely entry from Yanka Aguirre.
Should have done his calls no end of good.
Yeah, 85.8 helps when you're on the bubble, and he knows that. He's pleased. Confidence to take into his last dive. I'm sure we're going to see some movement on the leaderboard, though, with the sixth and final.
Alexander Bondar from Ukraine, 12th reverse 3.5 somersault tucked.
Well, when he's good, he's very good, Bondar. Ukraine wanting to get two athletes to progress.
Eighth in the World Championships at 10 metres in Shanghai last year.
Did get a little off the square, Bondar, but somehow on the way down rescued it and has pulled an 89.1. Just had that one bad dive, his third was a 57, otherwise in the 80s.
Jiho Park from Korea. He's 31st, back 2.5 somersault, 1.5 twists. Just needs to put in a nice clean dive to give himself some encouragement.
And he does that. He's towards the bottom of the field, ranked 31st, coming in to this fifth dive. And at this point, competing for pride, as we often say, there's something in that.
Studies and trains at the Korea University of Physical Education in Seoul. .72 his score there. Very consistent 7.5s right across. Viktor Minibayev. That view not for the queasy, is it? Back 3.5 somersault, piked 32 feet 10 inches above the water in old money. Back 3.5 somersault, piked 3.6 the degree of difficulty.
Well, he looked so good through the air. That's such a shame that he's spoiled it with that finish. Minibayev, look at the position he achieves here in pike. It's, those legs are so straight. Pulls for the water now and just over they go. Big splash. And that'll hurt Minibayev with a 48.6. Oh, he'd like to take that back, or at least the last bit.
No margin for error. Well, maybe a little bit tonight in terms of qualifying, but after that, you've got to get it right across the six dives if you're going to do yourself justice. German Sanchez has been fairly close to doing that. Fourth in the rankings to date. This is his fifth dive. It's a reverse 3.5 somersault tucked.
One of his easier dives.
In relative terms.
Oh, he does a good job with it too. I like him, German Sanchez. I think we will see him not just in the semi-final but the final. His class spots the water, goes in with a minimum of fuss and in good position.
He's in the flyweight division, remember, at only 47k. 7'6".
84.15. And he's on his way. What about Riley McCormick?
21 later this month. The Canadian. He is 14th. Reverse 3.5 somersault.
Again, just a little sloppy at the end for Riley, who can't make any big slip-ups here. He's only a few positions inside the cut. And again, overgo the legs with this sort of over-rotation at the finish. The timing is just so difficult to get spot on.
World Championship finalist in Shanghai last year, so he will have definitely set his stall out to be here tomorrow night, let alone tomorrow morning. Now, you'd give him 10 out of 10 for unpredictability, Matthew Mitchum, defending champion. And this is an arm stand back triple somersault. And there is a lot of him to get up level there.
and short. He managed to minimize the damage with the entry, but he wasn't vertical. And we're just gathering an impression, or at least I am, that he's not the diver he was 4 years ago. He still loves being on the Olympic stage, clearly, with his reaction. But you see, he's short there.
He doesn't lack personality. It's just form he seems to lack. Yeah. Certainly, it's not talent. We know that. He's proved that. You just feel he's a bit of a natural performer. If he could just get himself in the frame of mind, get himself in the final, he's one of those guys that if he has his day, it's a good day.
He was on my plane coming over from Sydney, and at the airport that people just couldn't get enough of him. He's so recognizable within Australia. And such a distraction for him, I think, at that level.
They're shy types really wouldn't be quite right in diving. It's a show-off sport, isn't it, basically? Amund Gismavik of Norway.
That's his best entry so far, Gismavik.
First Norwegian to qualify for the Olympics, remember, since 1992.
I think what you say, Roger, is a point worth elaborating, that some of the divers say, look, our bodies are on display, we're very much on display. You see all of us. Our courage is also exposed, and in that sense, it's no place for shrinking violets.
It's a performance. It's a show. It's the same with the gymnasts as well. You know, you can see they get the dismount right and the great smile, and they love the applause. That's the divers. I wonder how much of the applause they hear underwater, but I'm a feeling they sense it. Francesco Dell'Omo from Italy with a reverse 3.5 somersault. He's 21st. Not over for him yet by any means. He needs to get this 3.3 difficulty correct and get some points on the board.
Oh, and that's two consecutive average dives from Dell'Omo, and he was in contention to be in the semi-final two dives ago, and it's just slipping away from him now.
Thirty-two contestants, so it's a big field. It's a long time between the dives, but I do remember in the 3 meter springboard, which is probably the most contested category, they're having more than 50 divers for a world championship, and that is a long, long competition and a long wait between dives.
Eskilsson, sorry,
Christopher Eskilsson from Sweden. Where's he? 23rd equal.
Oh, and he, whatever is going wrong with Dell'Omo is going wrong with Eskilsson. That's twice now that both men have had a chance to make a statement late in the competition about forcing their way into the top 18, and they've just not delivered. This is a great shame. They're good enough, but there's the pressure. that intangible. You got the platform, you got the pool, and you got a very short amount of time to get it right. And it's what's between the ears that there can sometimes be the differential.
Eric Sain from Canada's first Olympic Games are proving a tough test for him. 28th versus a back 3.5 somersault. Canadians normally send quite a strong team with quite a high sense of ambition, so I think he'll be feeling the discomfort here, back in 28th position before these scores are added in.
Well, they've got such a great tradition, haven't they, in the sport. We look at Depaty, Alexander, one of the greats of all time, really. You can consider his longevity and success.
And they've got a couple of bronzes so far in this Olympics, so the team will be feeling confident, but he's just not had his day, has he?
No, 49.5 there for Eric. And I think he'd like it to be over now.
Brian Nixon Lomas from Malaysia. He's 26th. He has an inward 4.5 somersault. This is a really difficult dive. 4.1. 10 out of 10 for ambition.
Oh, and we'll give him high marks for execution too.
The coaching staff are happy. Could have just performed himself into the next round here, Lomasi. He's had a little bit of inconsistency through his competition this evening, but a very difficult dive done well. The degree of difficulty is really going to kick him up here. Smiles all around.
He's won Commonwealth Games medals and Asian Games medals, so he's used to performing and delivering a
96.
A good score, and 96 is a good score. Boy, it can change very dramatically, can't it? Gives you an idea of what lies ahead in this competition when it really starts to hot up over the next 24 hours. This is Ivan Garcia in sixth place, and he's got a reverse 3.5 somersault tucked here.
Might be able to hear our Spanish-speaking colleagues next door loving the Mexican performances and the way Guadalajara just rolls off the tongue. It is a beautifully named place, isn't it? I feel like I've got to go there just because of Guadalajara.
Famous World Cup football venue it was in Mexico. That's where its famous name in Britain. And Mexicans are showing that diving as well as football is one of their strong sports, and they're having a good games.
And an 85.8 for Ivan. He's looking pretty secure.
Two silver and a bronze for Mexico so far in these games, and they might fancy adding to that if their two divers really have a big night. Nick McCrory, 10th position. Back 3.5 somersault for the American bronze synchro medalist.
Well, it was okay. He's had his moments tonight as well. Needs to just be steady here and make sure he finishes it off. A top 10 diver when he's in form.
They're going to be back in less than 12 hours, so the schedulers have put them on the spot a bit, I think. 7 o'clock here in the UK it started, and it's not going to finish till after 10 o'clock, and then they're back at 10 o'clock in the morning. The time they get home and might need a massage. And
it is a tight schedule, isn't it? I looked at it and thought it's demanding on a number of people. Don't worry about us, but you know, crews and staff and of course the athletes. But that's Guerra.
He was in 22nd position with a reverse 3.5 somersault there. He'll be wanting to have a difficult 12 hours.
Lots of eights coming in. He's really got a few places to make up, though. With his fifth and sixth dives, 79.2. 18th, with some to come, though, with this fifth dive series.
Sebastian Villa now, 20-year-old Colombian, 23rd his ranking, back 3.5 somersault, which he delivers very quickly.
He does, and delivers well. Not much of a splash from a guy who's only some 54 kilos, 164 centimeters, not a lot of him. Finds the water. And good entry.
Don't think he's got a huge amount of experience at this level of competition, World Championship or Olympic, where it's a different world. The divers must find some of the performances of the top competitors intimidating almost. Not David Bodire, who's up next, though.
And again, you're getting a look at the good camaraderie down on the pool deck. So opposition coaches give some congratulations. The athletes walking past.
Back 3.5 somersault for David Bodire, who is 17th and just living on the edge a bit.
So there's little imperfections we're seeing from those below the top five as wonderful pike position. Stretches, reaches, splashes. So sevens. Seven and a halves. The eight will be discarded. And an 81. Difficulty helping him along there with a 3.6 tariff.
Chubo now leading the pack here for the 18-year-old.
Oh, how does he do it?
he bounced along that board before he got it, like it was a springboard almost.
Yes, a real looping approach, if you like. He's just very light on his feet, easy through the air, hits the water and not much of a splash, but making a few headlines. And Chubo is confirming his standing here with a 99.9.
As we said, he comes from a very poor background, and he knows that Olympic success will transform not only his life, but that of his family as well. This is Sasha Klein, who's doing very well, second place. Reverse 3.5 somersault there.
So he's trying to split the two Chinese champions, Chu and Lin. There's some 20 points difference between Chu and Lin. 466 to 445. We'll see if Sasha Klein can force his way in there. Very solid dive. And an 89-1.
26, this really could see him at his absolute peak. Just staying in the zone, I think they call that. In his own world there, isn't he, Lin?
Klein just 1 point behind Lin. Just couldn't sneak in ahead of him, but an 89. Very nice dive. Great result.
Vadim Kaptur from Belarus, 25-year-old from Minsk, 15th. Back 3.5 somersault. Needs to keep it going. Four world championships, 6 European championships. Got the experience. Has he got the points to keep it going?
Hasn't got the finish there. I'm afraid they're not cheering that dive. They're cheering the next competitor.
Yeah. 3.3 was the tariff there.
And they give us the names of the athletes and some of the sheets we have. They usually put the last name first. When I see Thomas Daly, it's presented to me as Daly Thomas. I nearly want to say Daly Thompson. But they're quite different sports and quite different bills. But maybe a taste of the same success from the great decathlete across to Thomas Daly.
Both have tremendous popularity. Tom Daly, 18 years of age, and getting better as the competition progresses. Back 3.5 somersault, 3.6 the tariff, and he is seventh after a shaky start.
Oh, my goodness. By his standards, that's a terrible ending to that dive. 3.6 degree of difficulty, but I think he's embarrassed to come up.
And he's putting this home support right through the mincer here, isn't he?
Won't do the confidence of his teammate Peter Waterfield any good. He's got to come up with two very good dives to make it to the semi. And a 39.6 sees him tumble to 16th.
Oh, this is a diver who set new British record points totals this year. We're not seeing it this evening. Andrea Ciarabini now from Italy, forward 3.5 somersault. And he's just really diving for personal pride. Back in 30th.
It's one of those young divers who will gain enormously from the opportunity to compete here, but it's not possible with his scores now to progress to the semi.
Just 17 years of age, we must emphasize again.
Hugo Parisi and then Waterfield. That'll complete the fifth dives.
Parisi is 28, This is a reverse 3.5 somersault tucked. And he's in 27th position, the Brazilian.
Nice dive. I just wonder at 28 whether he would be tempted to just hang on for Rio in 4 years' time. He'd be in his 30s. I mean, it's possible. Stay injury-free. This is one of his better ones. Fairly good vertical position for the entry from Hugo Parisi. Toes have got a good grip on the end of the platform there, acting like hands, really, with the grip. A little bit of excitement at the end of every series of dives because the last man up is the very popular Brit,
Peter Waterfield. And he, like Tom Daly, is making sure his many supporters have an anxious night. He too has been pulling his way up the field, but he too cannot afford to blow another dive. Reverse 3.5 somersault, he's in 20th position and diving to make the cut. Bit of a splash there, wasn't there?
That's not what he needed. It should have been tidier than that to just claw back a few more points and take some more pressure off. His fourth dive was so good, he really did something about his position. But that splash means he can only get sixes and six and a halves. Amazing range of dives there, between 4.5 and 7. Now that's some inconsistency there. I know those two scores come out, but you don't want to be seeing 4.5 and 7 as a range. They've got to be closer than that.
Well, he's piled all the pressure on himself for the last dive, but it's China 1 and 2. Sascha Klein, Germany, and the two Mexican divers, and Germany having a good evening. Martin Wolfram there, up into 6th. Matthew Mitchum, 10th. We should at least see him again. David Budaya as well, other big names. Gleb Galperin has slipped away a bit, like Tom Daly. Gleb Galperin had a very good start. Tom Daly, that disastrous dive, but still in with a chance. There's the cut, just behind James Connor, hanging on by his fingertips. Vadim Kaptur and Brian Lomas, the two divers most in touch. This is also where the program you've organized and just where you've put your bigger tariff dives can really make the big difference, can't it? Whether you've saved it for the end or put them in mid-competition. Crowd have stayed with it commendably all the way through the competition. Got a feeling this is very much the appetizer for the big one when it starts tomorrow and into tomorrow night.
Waterfield in 23rd position. That's tough to come back from.
Galperin started off like a train, but come a little bit off the rails in the latter stages. So he want to make sure he finishes strongly with this back 2.5 somersault, 2.5 twist with a 3.6 tariff.
Well, yes, just to extend the analogy a bit further, it's a train that's running out of steam, I think. That entry angle was seriously short of vertical. He's got great dives in him, but he needs 6 back-to-back to challenge the top few.
He's got a very distinguished career behind him, but again, those 8 operations on his back and knee. He missed 2 years of diving, done brilliantly to get back, but maybe he's just finding it a bit tougher to try and string a whole series of dives together. 81 points there with 7.5, the marks that count. He's got an anxious half hour just to make sure he comes back again. Yeah. Back at the top of the ranking, or second top, Lin Yue has beaten Chu, the world champion, at the national trials in May. So he's not come here for silver, but that is for tomorrow, of course. Back 2.5 somersault, 2.5 twist.
He's some 21 points behind his teammate. The finish of this dive, not quite perfect, but very tidy through the air. Now, just Beautiful gymnasts. Not too much wrong with that. He sort of collapsed into that somersault beneath the water. There's the crossover of the ankles there. The judges do well to see that. And an 86.4.
Had an injury to his waist over the last year or two, which is quite unusual. Must be running the core stomach muscles, which come under such a lot of strain. Victor Ortega from Colombia. He's ninth. Reverse 3.5 somersault. Just needs to keep it tidy.
If you're wondering what that tattoo is on his lower chest, it's life. That's what he embraces. Give it everything. And it's part of his sort of personal philosophy of how he approaches things.
It's a very individual sport that seems to attract individualists. A lot of them there, really strong characters with a bit of an artistic side to their nature, because they like to see it as what they're doing as being very creative.
Yes, it takes a certain type of person to want to jump off a 10-meter platform.
Anton Zakharov from the Ukraine. He's 14th. Back 2.5 somersault, 2.5 twist.
Very tidy.
What's his consistency been like over the evening?
Zakharov coming in at 14th before this dive, and he's had a near disastrous 47.25 as his fifth dive, but 70s, 80s, and now 86.4.
Well, he's got away with that that nightmare fifth dive, hasn't he, really?
There'll be some competitors here who'd like to have the option of dropping their worst dive, call it their mulligan. Not possible.
Timofey Hordeychik from Belarus, down in 29th. Reverse 3.5 somersault is his farewell dive.
Oh, he's just not able to control his entries. Makes a big splash, dive after dive. And that's not even with a poor position. So he's got to learn how that's done. There's a couple of tricks that happen under the water that he hasn't mastered.
After finishing 10th in the World Championships last year, I think he's going to get into bed tonight and think that he's not really done himself justice. Hyun-Joo Ri from Democratic People's Republic of Korea, the 16-year-old. Almost on work experience here, really. Down in 32nd place.
Oh, he's finished the competition well. His fifth dive was one of his best, and his last, clearly, his best.
Good. Really?
Yeah, that's right. You want to see them leave feeling good about themselves. It, we mentioned how much on display they are, and when you're this age, and your ego is a fragile thing.
It's the other noticeable aspect of these Olympics, that it's the highest level of competition, but away from that top, there is a great feeling of support from the crowds to competitors who are young or trying to make their mark.
Yeah, this is Jimmy Connor here at 17. He's right on the bubble at 18th. And there'll be a lot of people in Australia, family and friends, got their fingers crossed for this next dive. See if he can make it through.
Back 2.5 somersault, 1.5 twist.
Oh, he's done a fairly decent job of it too. So he's going to have to be beaten. He hasn't played himself out of contention. He's put in a good dive. And now the cards, let them fall how they may. And this is what you want to see. Everyone putting together a good competition so that if you get beaten by a better diver, that's okay. But rather than you not giving of your best.
I think it's the divers who've cut out the disasters who will feel that at least they've put on some sort of a show.
67.2. We're not with a high tariff there, so he's not been able to get into the 70s. But it may be enough. Depends on those around him, how they respond.
Martin Wolfram from Germany's had a good evening. Up in sixth. Forward 4.5 somersault. Powerful dive, that.
3.7 the tariff. Well, he's been tidy all evening and he's kept it going to the last. And something in the 90s here.
Really committed himself to that dive along the platform, didn't he? He's happy, and justifiably.
He's improved. He had two in the 70s, then two dives in the 80s, three in fact, and then one in the 90s. So he's one to watch.
Yankla Aguila, 12th, back 2.5 somersault, 2.5 twist for the Cuban, age 22, in his second Olympic Games.
Well, that's a busy dive, isn't it? There's a lot going on right there. 3.6 degree of difficulty, 2.5 twists, 2.5 somersaults. It's just a blur of limbs and torso spinning.
Well, after he reached the semi-final in Beijing, he will be looking for at least that 4 years on.
The mind is an amazing thing, that it can make the body do that so quickly. 84.6, Aguirre.
Alexander Bondar, who came eighth in the synchro competition, remember, the 18-year-old Ukrainian. Back 2.5 somersault, 2.5 twist to complete his program, and he is in seventh place.
Oh, another solid effort. He's had up to here, he's had four good dives and one poor one, and that's closer to good than poor.
I think he'll have his sights set on being here tomorrow night, not just tomorrow morning.
Yes, not quite as clean perhaps as the Chinese with his leg form and his the pike position he briefly gets into here. Those knees were bent. 81 though, with that 3.6 tariff. And he's done enough, I'm sure.
Jiho Park from Korea, from Busan. 28th arm stand, back double somersault, 1.5 twists. And he's got to get up into that arm stand position.
It was a real effort getting away from the platform, wasn't it? There's a little microphone up there to catch any noises coming from the divers. And yeah, just another man gathering experience, you feel.
It's the arm strength needed to get some height from that, not just fall away into the dive, just collapse into it. The top exponents there really pushing, pumping themselves away from the platform.
Yes, he's not the most powerfully built of the divers we have here. Victor Minabayev.
Back 2.5 somersault, 2.5 twist. Now he's in 17th place with not much room to spare. 18, remember, is the cutoff point. Back 2.5 somersault, 2.5 twist.
Well, if he was in trouble before, he's not now. Fourth at the Worlds last year in Shanghai, you look at that and realize that he's got something more in him. And there it is. He's delivered, and he'll be fine because he's got a good score coming here.
current European silver medalist, so he's a man with expectations to succeed and perform.
When you see a dive like that, you wonder what was he doing 17th with one dive to come. That doesn't help James Connor, who's the man on the cusp, if you like, as Minabayev sort of blows him away. He was already in front of him, but only just.
German Sanchez from Mexico in fourth place. Forward 4.5 somersault to finish up with. And he's put down an encouraging marker, the Mexican.
A little sloppy from him. He won't put himself in danger, though. He's too high up the rankings to fall out of the top 18. But this one was overdone.
That extra fourth rotation takes a little bit of pulling out of, and they're running out of space to do it.
66.6. Secret handshake exchanged, and on we go.
Riley McCormick from Canada, 13th place, back 3.5 somersault. Didn't make the final in Beijing, he was 16th.
And another man who I think is now safe. Certainly couldn't afford a major mistake sitting 13th, but with this dive, we can count him in. Nicely executed, reaches for the water, maybe not quite vertical, but he's got that skill of minimizing the splash. I'll be all right. 86.4. Yeah, a little sigh of relief there. I'm sure he must have known in his heart he had it covered, but you're still in the hands of the judges, aren't you?
Matthew Mitchum, defending champion. 10th place after five dives, back 2.5 somersault, 2.5 twists. What is the Australian going to come up with this time?
Oh, one of his better ones. And I think we've just got another locked into the top 18. He looked less than his best early in the competition, but he's starting to find form. He might tell us later that he always had it under control. And he looks safely through the Beijing champ.
I think he is a sort of highly experienced competitor who knows that he's just got to get himself through this, you know, and it's not being won tonight. But he's has been a tad unpredictable.
84.6, though. We'll see him safely across the line and into morning competition.
Amund Gismavik from Norway, down in 24th, finishes with an inward 3.5 somersault tucked.
Very nice. He's had a couple of good dives and a few not really Olympic class, but I like what he's offered here at the end. And he's pulling some good scores for it too. Maybe just came in a little nervous at 21 and so pretty good on the 1 meter springboard, so he's got a range of skills across the disciplines. And
up now with Francesco Dell'Uomo from Italy, arm stand forward double somersault with one twist, which is only worth 3.1. he's in 26th place, just getting himself up into that position. Thank you.
It's such a disappointing thing because his first three dives were so good, and now, if you'll pardon the obvious pun, he's plummeted out of contention with just a drop-off in form that maybe comes from confidence. The fourth dive was poor, so was the fifth, the sixth. He had little chance by this stage.
He was almost dropping into that dive there. The top divers have really snapped themselves still out of that arm stand position.
60.45 for Francesco.
Christopher Eskilsson from Sweden. He's 27th. Forward 4.5 somersault to end.
Didn't quite reach that desired position for the entry. It's such a lot of somersaults to get through. 4.5 of them. 3 points. It's his most difficult dive. He saves it, not illogically, for last. But I just wonder, too, if there isn't an argument for putting them in a little earlier when you know the competition's going to go for 3 hours plus.
Rather than trying to rely on keeping your concentration and form and confidence going over what amounts to a 3 hour competition. Eric Sain from Canada, down in 30th position. Not had the best of nights. Reverse 3.5 somersault to finish off.
Not a lot of elevation off the platform just to rip through these somersaults, but does a good job, really. By the time he reaches the water, he's got it under control. And oh, that camera angle is just frightening, isn't it, when you see how close the head goes.
Maybe it's a bit like the view from the passenger seat sometimes when it's it looks worse from there than it does when you're the actual driver, but you shudder at the thought if they just catch themselves. We wouldn't be the first at all, but no wonder they get injured.
Brian Lomas.
Back 2.5 somersault, 2.5 twist. 20th. Can he?
Oh, maybe. Oh, this is one for the calculator and the judges. And we'll wait for the tabulation to be done at the end. But I think he's improved his position here a little. That's a good dive from Brian. So 4 8s, two of them rejected, but 8s and a 7.5 and an 84.6 is that's a much bigger score than James Connor got for his last dive.
Well, he has dived in World Championship finals, so he will have come in here hoping. Ivan Garcia of Mexico, 5th ranked, forward 2.5 somersault, 3 twists, and he's had an encouraging evening.
Didn't need his dive in this last series to be anything too special, and well, frankly, it wasn't, but he's got a lot of room to play with.
The synchro silver medalist, remember? And he might be one of those divers who's looking to continue to improve throughout the competition and maybe mount a medal challenge if others don't deliver of their best.
A high tariff there helping boost his score to 79.8.
Now Nick McCrory, back 2.5 somersault, 2.5 twists. In 8th, pretty comfortable. 3.6 the tariff. We'll just want to sign off nice and clean and then head off for a night's rest.
Yeah, that'll give him some confidence. No nightmares with his last dive. No, he's a world top 10 diver, 6th at the world's last year. clean. Nice entry. Tall man at 180 centimetres or 5'11". So there's a bit more of him to get around and a bit more of him to make a splash, but he's got it all under control.
Job done in general terms tonight for Nick. Good job, as American coaches like to say, I think. Yeah. Good job.
Azeguera. Yeah,
he's 21st, back 2.5 somersault, 2.5 twists, 3.6. Needs to pull out a bit of a blinder here.
Which he does. Giving himself an outside chance here. Azeguera. From Santiago de Cuba, the veteran in the field at 33.
Competed in 5 world championships.
A couple of 8.5s and a 9 are going to count here for a big last effort of 93.6. And he's up to 16th.
Not bad for a 33-year-old. Sebastian Villa now from Colombia. 22nd position. Finishes with a reverse 3.5 somersault. And he needs some really strong marks here.
Pulls it around. And there's that effort of straightening up that left him bent at the hips a little. He's just too flexible. Also competes on 1 meter and 3 meter springboard.
Up now to David Budaya, the synchro bronze medalist from what must seem like a long time ago, the beginning of last week. He's 11th. Back 2.5 somersault, 2.5 twists to complete his evening's work.
There's such a range of body types competing in this platform event. He's a big, strong man, powerful shoulders, the shoulders of a gymnast. That's a splash he won't be pleased he didn't see.
So he did start as a gymnast, actually. He broke a bone in his foot and felt that it was just a bit burned out by gymnastics, so decided diving off 10 metres was a more comfortable way to go. Takes all sorts.
Well, it's a very demanding sport to stick with. David Budaya, 17th position, and things looking shaky for James Connor.
Now
we'll be able to bring you the final 18 shortly.
Chubo, the 19-year-old. The favourite from China. Back 2.5 somersault, 2.5 twist.
I was just looking at this. He didn't actually need to do that last dive. So far ahead, without doing it, he would have qualified in the top 10. So great thrust away from the platform, into his twists. And again, what an entry. In this form, he looks untouchable.
His arm movements through that. He's in one position for the twist, then down back behind to hold up the pike, and then out. So much going on, as you've said before, in so many different parts of his body.
And a 97.2. He's at 299s.
Sascha Klein from Germany. Third after 5 dives. Back 2.5 somersault, 2.5 twists. Again, looking to leave on a high.
Well, that wasn't his best dive. It'd be very tempting to switch off when you're in his position. He's so firmly entrenched in the top. Getting late, local time, a bit after 10 in the evening.
3 hours of competition, tough on divers. Give a thought for the judges as well. That's a lot of concentration going on.
My real sympathy, though, is with the competitors, because it's not easy to finish a competition, go back to the village and get yourself to sleep within a couple of hours of competing, because you're pumped.
And they've got to refuel. They'll need to take the right things on board and get some rest.
I think the scheduling's crazy. I'm just amazed about the short turnaround.
Vadim Kaptur from Belarus, 19th, just on the outside looking in, reverse 3.5 somersault to save it.
I mean, if we finish work at 5 o'clock in the afternoon, we're not expected to be back at work at 5 in the morning. And that's the ask here. Kaptur finishes his evening's work.
Now, Tom Daley is up next. That's where you can hear the crowds. Let's just confirm Kaptur's mark.
64.35, and he can have a bit of a lie-in tomorrow. And it's not like they just turn up at 10 o'clock in the morning either. They're here early to warm up. Here's a big moment, though.
Massive cheer. Can't afford to have another disaster. 16th after round five, and really, we've had all sorts so far. You can hear the, feel the crowd just willing one more strong dive from their local hero.
There you go. Well, maybe. I called it a bit early because he's flipped the feet over, but the crowd certainly had their say. He's got just a bit to play with the top 18 going through, and he was sitting 16.
They are willing him on. He's everybody's favourite son. And they would all just love him to do well. It really is a supportive sound, I feel, not just a pressure, if he can see it like that.
He's going to make it. He's through. He's ranked 15th, and there's three to come, and we know a couple of them are no chance. So he is into the semi-final, Thomas Daley.
Maybe not quite the way he was looking. That will, of course, affect his dive position tomorrow in the batting order. Andrea Chiarabini, who's pretty out of it. Back 2.5 somersault, 1.5 twists to end up what's not been his greatest night, but at 17, a key learning experience in his sporting career.
And he has finished off nicely here, Roger. This is one of his better dives. Pressure's off. And that sometimes has a bit to do with it when you know you can't progress. The weight comes off the shoulders. Nicely done. 75.2. So he's got it in him.
He'll be back. He sticks at it and keeps the appetite. And fancies a trip to Rio. And who wouldn't? Hugo Parisi. Who knows all about Rio, although he is from Brasilia. Back 2.5 somersault, 2.5 twist.
And again, just a bend at the hips, and that spoils the entry. And creates that big splash. So Parisi not quite there, finishing towards the bottom of the field. Some kind of a miracle needed with the last dive for our last man.
Making sure the competition comes to a dramatic conclusion. Peter Wartfield of Great Britain, massive cheer, but he has got work to do. 23rd, he's got an Olympic silver medal, remember, in synchro, and he needs to draw and all that experience and all that talent now to be back tomorrow morning. Big moment for a local lad born just down the road.
Oh, just a little short. A punch of the water underneath the surface, and I don't know if it's enough. He needs around 440 in total.
He's been such a storming influence in British diving for more than a decade, competing in world championships right back in 1997, but this may well prove a trip too far.
And 23rd is his ranking. He couldn't pull the enormous score that he needed, and so Budaya is the last man in. Oh, that would have been quite a sensation if he'd missed.
There's the ranking. The two Chinese divers setting the standard, Sascha Klein and Martin Wolfram. A good night for Germany and for Mexico. Alexander Bondor, Nick McCrory from Ukraine and the United States respectively. Matthew Mitchum, more to come from him. Anton Zakharov, Victor Minibayev, Tom Daly, the local hero in 15th. Gleb Galperin fading rather, but showing he's got ability. These marks will not count tomorrow. They start again from scratch. David Budaya, Jose Guerra, and Brian Lomas and Jimmy Connor, the two most disappointed men, really. They just miss the cut. They are on standby, I think, but these divers can just put it down to a massive Olympic experience. A long night of competition here, but I've got a feeling overall, Steve, that it is an appetizer, and the top men, although we've seen some outstanding performances at the top end, are really just warming up and getting into their stride.
I just felt that Chubot didn't have to dive as well as he did, but he's in doing so, he's made a statement. He's some 31 points clear of Ligneux, and then back to Klein. So 5.63 for Chubot. Go back to third, 5.25, and that is a massive amount to make up. And there were no weaknesses in Chubot's performance. So he looks good for the gold and for China to continue their dominance.
He has been beaten before, Chubot. Tom Daly famously did it in 2009 when the pressure did get to him, but he's a more experienced diver now, and it is that ability to just churn out these top quality dives. He's not yet dazzled, but I don't think he's been under the pressure to really do everything he can do. He knows he's got plenty spare, but a great appetizer. This is a great event.
And we're looking forward to just seeing more great dives. We don't care who they come from, because we're being richly entertained here at the Aquatic Center. And it's dramatic stuff off the platform, and wonderful skills and courage that we're observing, and we're looking forward to more of it.
I think the divers will go away, some with encouragement, some knowing they've got something to learn from it, some tonight knowing that after all that build-up and all that work, it's been a bitterly disappointing evening for them. But at the top end, though, we really have seen some quality. Chubot is a sight to behold when he's in top form.
He's still got a job to do tomorrow, twice over, and we're looking forward to bringing that to you from the Aquatic Centre.
A very difficult night ahead then for 18 divers to get their rest, get themselves mentally prepared, and be back at 10 o'clock tomorrow morning.